The road to the dome is long, winding, and with plenty of exit ramps marked no re-entry. Our journey began 100 punishing days ago as teams endured the scorching heat of August, the frosty nights of fall, and everything in between. Up before daybreak, busting it well past dark, hitting the same 100 yards over and over and over. Then a few moments of Friday night glory before going back to the laps and the weights and the drills until you were ready to drop. But you kept going. Now, you've reached your final destination. You have arrived. Come with us as the best of the best find out if they have what it takes to be called champion.
Get ready for some exciting high school football as the Carrollton Trojans take on the Griffin Bears, live on GPB next.
Time to play some football.
That's a championship team right there.
It's a hot time tonight.
Nighttime approaches in the city of Atlanta. It is championship weekend here for the 2013 Tommy Gillibo GHSA High School Football Championships. It is time for championship game 6 of 7. In the AAA class, it is the class in Quad A. It is Carrollton coming in out of Region 5 at 13-1. And the Griffin Bears coming in out of Region 4 with a picture-perfect 14-0. Thanks for accessing us however you are doing so, whether it is on GPB TV, whether it's on GPB.org or on the GPB Sports app. I'm John. This is Keelan. And with the pedigrees that these two programs have, you'd have thought that these two teams have played each other a lot. Last time, the anniversary, 1923. But Keelan, the way that these two teams go, we could either be out of here in an hour and a half, or we could be here until Tuesday.
Yes, you're exactly right. Both of these teams, they execute their offense and they play well on defense, quite frankly, and it's pretty good. And one team really loves to wing tee it, and the other team really loves to throw the football at that jump.
So we're gonna have the wing and the wing tee. Carrollton, first championship game since 2010, chasing after their first title since 1998. And on defense, it is the man in the middle that makes him go.
Yeah, the man in the middle that makes it go. He controls the line of scrimmage. Dontavious Russell, All-American. Deep tackle, one of the top deep tackles in the nation. This young man has very aggressive feet, and he's very aggressive with his hands getting to the second level of the offense.
Griffin, on the flip side, has not been in a championship game since 1980, have not won since 1978.
Right.
Some news offensively, Malik Miller, their top running back, injured in a Malcolm Mitchell-like accident, celebrating on the sidelines for the Sandy Creek game. He is out. Things are going to be very different for Griffin offensively, but the man who makes them go, the quarterback, Jaquez Parks.
Yeah, Jaquez Parks is a major, major specimen to this offense. He does so much for them. His completion rate is 72% on the year, and guess what? His GPA is 3.8. GPA, this young man can go to Harvard, he can go to Yale, he may be going to Air Force, but this young man is definitely smart, and he does the offense quite right when he's on the field.
Two great towns when it comes to the history of Georgia high school football, playing here tonight in Griffin and in Carrollton. Raven Tirado tells us how unique one of these towns really is. Raven.
That's right, John. Griffin has a lot of colorful people coming out of it. 17 NFL players, including a man you might know, Jesse Tuggle, every Clemens this side of the Mississippi. But on top of that, they've had the likes of Doc Holliday, that's right, the gunslinger, gambler, the outlaw, if you will, that headed out west, that was also a dentist. They also had Lake Sidney Lanier, actually Sidney Lanier, the poet. Honey Boo Boo, remember that show? June? She went to Griffin High School, so a lot of interesting people to come out of the city of Griffin, showing you why it's great to be a Georgia Peach. Back up to you, John.
Thank you very much, Raven. She'll be patrolling the sidelines for us this evening. A long weekend for her, a long weekend for a lot of us, but we wouldn't have it any other way. The man in charge in Carrollton, Ray Van Tee.
He's definitely bringing a lot to the table, this young man. It's one of these things where he knows his team is ready. He
Talk
knows
about what, the Trojan keys right there.
The Trojan keys, first and foremost, they on the offense, they really have to protect the rock. They do a lot of things with the wing tee. They have a lot of movement with their running backs, so they really have to protect the football today. On the defense side of the ball tonight for them, they really have to be very aggressive, and they have to stay in their lanes. As for Griffin on offense, finding some type of running game, first and foremost on the defense side of the ball, they have to make adjustments on the fly.
Head coach for Griffin is Steve Dvorsny. He has built a great program there at Griffin in his 13th season, 127-35. He won as a player in 1988 at Robert E. Lee. Bit of trivia for you. The head coach was Mike Swaney, who won in Marion County. There's Ray Van Teek, part of the Billy Henderson coaching tree at Clark Central. Head coach at Lafayette, at Swainsboro, and at Carrollton, 24th season overall, 220-68-1. So we're going to light this quad A candle. Carrollton has won the toss, and they will take the ball first. Keelan, you said that somebody's going to wing tee it. The other team's going to just flat out wing it. Griffin, looks like they broke out their dress blacks for the evening. Carrollton, black helmets and in their white. And there's your series history, 2-for-1. Griffin, first meeting since 1922, so 91 years. This game is in the making, and we are underway for the Quad A Championship here at the Georgia Dome. Fielded at the 20, and a lot of Griffin Bears swarming to the football for Carrollton. It's going to be a start on offense inside their own 20.
You talk about swarming to the football. That's what they really do really good on the defense side of the ball. One thing you can tell about the identity of a football team is their kickoff team, the way they run down the field, and because that's the first thing everybody's going to see tonight is their defense. So they definitely set the tone on the kickoff.
Senior Will Garrett will be calling the plays. You see him completing about 60% of his passes in this wing tee offense, but you divide 101 by 14, it's about 7 passes a game. It's more out of necessity and changeup than it is a part of the offense. Wing tee set for Carrollton. Jet sweep on the first play. Nothing happening. East, west, and out of bounds.
Just a very good job by staying gap sound on the offense side, the defense side of the ball for Griffin. Good job by Nick Williams to push him out of bounds.
Let's take a look at the Trojans' offense. Starting lineups brought to us by our friends at Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Sanders, Newsom, Sauls, King, and Sears tackle to tackle. Your skill players, Andrew Turner, Malik Shepard, Trey Shivers, Cole Cook, and one of the best names of the weekend to catch a pass, you've got to have Dante Wigley. Looks like Steve Dvorsny saw something that he didn't like, so he called a timeout 10 seconds in.
Hey, a lot is riding on this football game. If you're the head coach, you don't see something you like, hey, let's fix it now, because if later in the game, it's going to be too late to call those timeouts.
Now we talk about the pedigree of Griffin when it comes to just people who were born and raised. Here's your NFL alumni, and one of those guys, the guy at the top,
look at that.
He's
list.
Hanging in the rafters up here, the Hammer.
That is a very, very nice list. As you go down the line here, you see some big time players there. Freddie Gilbert, Nick Clemens, Georgia guy. Chris Clemens, another Georgia guy, somebody that we all know in the community is doing great things in the NFL.
Freddie Gilbert, and let's go to the bottom of that ladder. John Brewer played for the Dayton Triangles for 9 seasons in the early inclinations of pro football in the United States. 17 Griffin Bears have made it from the high school level to the NFL, and you see right there what hard work can do, and hard work always brought the hammer when you're wearing 5'8".
It definitely does. This is a classification that was up and down all year, but both of these teams are well-deserved to be here in the Dome tonight.
Inside handoff up the middle, nothing happening there. One more time, let's take a look at the Griffin defensive starters. Brought to us once again by our friends at Regents Bank. It's time to expect more. Nike Floyd, Ronquavious Davis, Noah Clowers, Jonathan Frost, Nick Williams, Telly Sloan, 152 tackles on the year for number 6. Jordan Colbert, the other linebacker. Your defensive backs, Brown, Stroud, Devontae Freeman, and Montico Dodson. Because of the injury to Malik Miller, you could see Freeman on the offensive side of the ball. Number 1 playing both ways this evening. Third down, 10. Carrollton, first possession, outside shoulder, complete first down.
Just a very nice, safe, high percentage pass for the quarterback. Will Garrett just getting out of the pocket. Nice catch by Andrew Turner. You can see he gets separation from the defensive back. He catches that ball and gets both feet in for the first down.
Outside shoulder throw, 12 yards there for the first down for Turner. Third down and 10, necessity down to throw for Carrollton out of the wing tee offense. Ray Van Teek is more than happy to get 10 feet of play. You do that 3 times, it's a first down. We got whistles and flags. Man in the white hat, Mike Boyd.
Dead ball, encroachment on the defense, 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
Brian Bugner, Richard Harris, Marcus Wood, Mark Demise, and Jeff Williams, the rest of your crew here this evening.
I ran this offense in high school in Atlantic High School, and the wing T is a very effective offense. If you get your defenders to make one mistake, it can easily go straight to the touchdown. That's why this offense is so high post out.
Wing T once again inside handoff, nothing doing. Once again, Telly Sloan in the middle of it all.
Linebackers are very active in this football game so far. You can see Nick Williams and Telly Sloan just coming up the line of scrimmage, taking on those blocks. Good job by this defensive line is creating those lanes for those linebackers. That's one thing about playing defensive line. You have to be able to create alleys for your linebackers to make plays.
There's Telly Sloan's numbers, 21 tackles for loss and 3 sacks, averaging about 11 tackles a game. Outside shoulder throw one more time, complete. And it is close to a first down for Carrollton. Brandon Walton, one of the big tight ends. He's got 6'6", 225 on the catch.
This is the matchup that you want. If you're Carrollton, this is the matchup that you're looking for all night. A smaller defensive back in Brown, a bigger receiver there on the outside, just making sure you get the sure first down. Nice 5-yard stop that moves the change.
Move the sticks, minute 45 in. Ball first down at the 40. Back to the running game. Second man through, nothing doing, maybe a yard. Malik Shepard, leading rusher for Carrollton, getting the carry there, getting the yard. Second down and 9, 2:10 in.
Expect a heavy dose of Malik Shepard tonight. He's the fullback. He's the dive guy. It's somebody who's definitely going to touch majority of the football tonight.
Going to come at you in waves with number 1, Trey Shivers, Jarvis Terrell, and Malik Shepard. Throwing once again, complete in the flat inside the 50, down to the 45. Moving the sticks for a gain of 14.
Just a very nice route by Andrew Turner, getting down. If you look at him bending his knees, getting down to catch that ball, that's one thing you really want to see from your receivers, getting down and giving that great effort.
Tackle by Montico Dodson that time. Once again, gain of 14. Carrollton moving the sticks once again. And they'd be more than happy to take the entire time of possession here in the first quarter, moving it down the field. Jet sweep inside. Trey Shivers cuts it twice. Grabbed from behind and DDT'd into the ground inside the 35. Anthony Stroud coming up over the top to make the stop, but not after a big game.
As you see the cutback lanes right there by Trey Tribes, just making sure he stays with this blocking. Sometimes that blocking is pushing up the field, and the cutback lane is wide open. Nice vision by the running back, number 1, Trey.
Shivers gets 9. There's his numbers. Averaging over 8 yards a carry this season. Dive, nothing happening. Surprising no one, Telly Sloan right in the middle of it one more time. It's going to be a busy day for number 6.
It's going to be a very busy day. One thing about this offense, you have to be able to hit the fullback every single time. If you're a defender, you have to be accountable for him, and that's his job, and he's definitely doing that so far tonight.
Telly Sloan has his eyes on the Carrollton offense. Loss of 1 makes it second down and 11 at the 35. Dive through, cut back inside down to the 25, about a yard short for the first down, Malik Shepard.
One thing I really like what Will Garrett is doing, he's falling out his fakes. He's keeping that defense honest, and if you're the quarterback, you continue to fall off your fakes. When it's your number, the defense will not expect you to have the football. So you have to keep everything the same. Repetition. I'm sure they ran this play a lot in the offseason, all year round. You have to be consistent if you're the quarterback.
Ryan Cochran in on the carry, going to dive over the center just to move the sticks and get the first down. Looks like he got it. Motion made by the wide hat. First down by Will Garrett.
As you can see, Carrollton is taking their time. They're not pressed for time here. This is what this wing T offense is all about. It's meant to grind you out, to get your defensive line tired, to get this linebackers tired. They're going to get tired of hitting. If you're coming full speed at me all the time, I'm going to get tired of hitting you.
And those threes and fours that you want in the first quarter turn into sevens and eights. Hand off once again on the sweep. Cut back, Trey Shivers, touchdown. 24 yards for Trey Shivers. Carrollton on the board first.
As you can see how consistent this offense is, they continue to run the same play over and over again, just out of different formations. That's a very nice job by being patient, waiting on this offensive lineman, going down the field. And one thing I really like about Malik Shumpert throwing that block into the safety for the cutback allows him to get the touchdown.
Point after is up and good. Touchdown replay by our friends at the Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. Carrollton doing it on the ground. Big cut back by Trey Shivers. No surprise for the Trojan fans. The first seven on the board are from Carrollton.
My husband, Corky Kill, was a beloved father, husband, and coach. Corky passed away from lung cancer less than 7 months after his diagnosis. Lung cancer is curable if diagnosed early. Unfortunately, there are many people who are at risk but can't afford an early screening.
Early lung cancer screenings help save lives. A message from Corky Kell Early Lung Cancer Detection Fund. For information, 770-956-GIVE.
Welcome back, Georgia Dome. 706 for the first. Carrollton and their vaunted running game puts the seven on the board against Griffin. Keelan, take us through it.
I just want to point something out about blocking downfield. If you look at these running backs here, and keep your eye on this fullback right here, okay? Watch him down the field. He's going to throw a nice block in on this safety. That's what definitely makes this play work on the, with the cutback. If you're a running back, you have to be able to block downfield. You have to, it's all about effort. And watch this block right there.
Nice cutback by Shivers after working his way through. And one more time. There's your cutback in the score. Shivers, two carries, 35 yards on the drive. Scoring drive brought to us by our friends at TCSG as well. 85 took them 12, and they took 5 minutes off the clock.
You talk about the unselfish effort, and Coach talked about we have running backs by the committee here. And these guys, they love watching each other score touchdowns, high-fiving each other. The energy level is always high. Coach is like, hey, it's kind of competition with these guys. Who's going to carry the ball the most, and who's going to do something with the rock? That's why they're running game. It's good.
Tyler Newsom committed to Notre Dame, foot into the football, and we'll see what Griffin will do. First time on offense, picked up outside the five, out to the 20, and that's where the Griffin Bears will start.
The key here for Griffin, in order for them to win this football game, they have to be disciplined. You know, they have to minimize the penalties. They have to stay gap sound. They also have to execute on offense too as well. They have to find some type of running game because they do not have a running game right now. Their starting running back got hurt a few weeks back, and they're going to be looking to go to the air, but they have to find something that can help them in the running game.
We saw Jaquez Parks almost 4,400 yards of total offense so far in this offense this season, averaging 300 a game. Clear out pattern works, 25, just shy of the 30. And let's take a look at the Griffin offense once again, brought to us by our friends at Regions Bank. It's time to expect more, and obviously with Griffin working, we're going to do this quickly. William, Schoetz, Martin, Dennis, and Stanford tackle to tackle, and your skill players Willis, Mangum, Owens, Fuller, and Quadius Weems.
Tempo is everything. Fast pace is everything to this offensive coordinator. Their job is also to get the defense tired as well.
Zone read, first down on Jaquez Parks running up the middle, just shy of the 35. Let's take a look at the Carrollton defense. Once brought to us by our friends at Regions Bank. And they kind of run a 5-3 or a 3-3-5. They'll kind of send eight or drop eight. That's your front five. Rory Glanton and Cade Crawford, your two linebackers. Corners, Wigley, Turner, Johnson, and Cammons. You can call this an amoeba defense, call it what you will. Ray Van Teague really didn't have a name for it. He just sends a lot or drops a lot. Parks looking from the 25. Inside picked off by Carrollton. Running it back, 30, 25, 20. Tackled inside the 20-yard line. and number 14, 28 yards on the return. And Carrollton, the inch and Cammons with the pick. Carrollton in business.
Just look at this coverage here, just coming in, robbing that curl route. It's a very nice job, and had four INTs coming into this game. Now he's going to lead the building with five so far. This is a very nice defensive effort.
Here's a look from behind Parks. There's your Cammons poaching the route, getting it inside the 20. Couldn't set up any better for Carrollton in the offense. Once again, handoff looking to find a hole. Won't find one this time. Malik Shepard trying to work it to the outside. Maybe a yard. Looks like they gave him two, so it'll be second down and eight. Carrollton more than happy to sit there and look at the 25-second clock. Take as much of it as possible off before snapping the football, because they know how tough this Griffin offense is and how quickly they can score. Dive faked, stays with Garrett, crosses over the 10-yard line, so another 2-yard gain. Once again, Carrollton is on schedule as they head to third down.
There you go. Quarterback decides to keep the football. Defense stayed at home, and somebody was responsible for the quarterback. Those are the things that they have to stay disciplined. But when you get to the second level and the running back's back there, your safeties and your linebackers have to make plays. They have to tackle the running backs.
Third down six, just inside the 9-yard line. Crisscross handoff, touchdown Shivers. Nine yards for Shivers, and he has made an impact early.
Second touchdown tonight for him. Just doing another nice job. You see the double reverse right there coming across. And like I said, the secondary just have to make those plays. If you can't tackle, it's going to be a long night.
Newsom setting up for the PAT out of the swinging gate. Kick is up and good. And another quick strike for an offense that's used to taking a lot of time off the clock.
Well, you know, with the turnover on the short field, a nice 28 return with the interception put them in a great position on the field. Three plays, 44 yards.
Not a bad average if you're Shivers so far. Trying to do my math, it's about 14.7. Let's take a look at it one more time. He's had a busy night so far.
You see how active he is, constantly moving his feet. Not easy to tackle in open field, but also number one, very patient with his eyes. Something that a running back needs to have. He definitely had those components.
And there's Trey Shivers. Here's your scoring drive. Once again, brought to us by our friends at Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. 13 yards, took him only three plays, minute 14. There's your math, 14.7 a carry and two scores for number one.
Young man is looking at Western Kentucky and Cincinnati, some teams that they're coming to the schools.
Kick into the end zone, touchback. Griffin will start their second possession from the 20. 4:46 for the first. A bit of an adjustment for both of these teams. The freshmen for Carrollton have been to the Dome. They know what it's like to chase after a championship, having only been here a couple of years ago. There's Steve DeBoersny. Once again, the team has not won a state title since 1978, hasn't been in a title game since 1980, losing to Lowndes. Parks dropping back with five wide. Looked like a screen, batted down.
Getting into passing lanes for these defensive ends, these D linemen, doing a great job. Cole Cook just getting his hands up, getting it. Jaquez Parks throwing lane there, because they throw the ball very, very nicely. Throw it down the field a lot, but they really like those screens and those outs. And if you're a defensive lineman, you got to get your hands up to have some type of chance here in this ball game.
Cook committed to NC State. Tremendous family pedigree as well. His mom played for Pat Summitt at the University of Tennessee, so he knows all about blocking shots. Parks winding up, throws toward the sideline. In and out of the hands, incomplete to Keyston Fuller. So that'll create third down.
Just a nice coverage on the edge by number four, Dante Wingley. You play till the whistle's over, and that's what I'm talking about, baby, right there. You just got to send the message early. Not in my house, baby.
Dante Wingley with the hit right there, making the receiver Wingley for a change.
Something I used to partake in.
Getting Wingley?
No, giving the receivers Wingley.
Just checking. 4:35 for the first. Griffin's offense so far has been stifled. Third down, 10. Screen is an option for Jaquez Parks. Too much time. A lot of great coverage in the secondary. Loops it over the top. Complete. 40, 45. Midfield inside the 40. Caught from behind at the 30. 50-yard pickup for Griffin, and they needed that big. Trey Willis.
You're talking about an impromptu. You're talking about giving Jaquez Parks time. You see what happens. He's just patient, waiting patiently. And I'm telling you, a three-man rush there by the defense. Somebody has to get to the quarterback. If you don't get to the quarterback with a three-man rush, this will happen. And they did a real good job by executing. That's why if you're a receiver, your quarterback scrambling, you have to stay active. You have to keep your feet alive because you never know when that ball's coming.
Five wide in the pattern, zone read. Parks takes it himself on the draw. Gets it close to the 25, down to the 26. Gain of 4, second down and 6 for the offense.
We talk about Parks' IQ level, 3.8 GPA with 1150 on the SAT. But also look at his quarterback IQ on the football field. That's why Griffin is here in the state title tonight.
Air Force Academy, Harvard. A lot of high profile schools chasing after a talent in the classroom and on the field. Gave him 5, second down and 5. Jet sweep, near side, cut back 25, 20, 15, inside the 15-yard line. Devontae Freeman, we figured we might see him on offense, coming over from defense because of the lack of depth. But a false start moves it back. Wipes out a great game. Steve DeVore's and he asking question.
Dante Freeman, you can see what type of athlete he is. He's going to be busy tonight on the defense side of the ball. So coach said we're going to use him maybe for 10 to 15 plays, try to get something going. And this is the time when the ball is around the 30 yard line. You see a lot of teams try to do some reverses or trick plays. This is where they start to happen. As you can see, Deontay Freeman is going to be involved in that.
Five wide going out one more time. Over the top, Parks caught, touchdown Griffin. Yards on the catch. Trey Willis. Nice touch by Jaquez Parks to get the Griffin Bears on the board.
You're asking a Mike linebacker to cover a high skilled receiver. It's not going to happen. I like my chances over my receiver against your linebacker any day. They caught them. They caught Carrollton in the wrong defense, and Griffin caught them in the right play, which is what happens sometimes.
Jaquez Parks holding on the PAT, looked at the Carrollton setup, decided, okay, we're going to go for one instead of two. Snap is down, and the kick is good. Griffin working their way down the field for their first 7 on the night. There's the man right there, Trey Willis, that got the touchdown pass.
You can see Trey Willis. Coach talked about his athleticism. He's a track guy, somebody who definitely brings a lot to the table when it comes to the speed of the outside of this offense. But he goes right up to middle. The linebacker, and you look, take a look at the lone pass. Give Jaquez Parks some time, and it's a nice little touch on the football, and he nearly takes that one to the house there, John.
Trey Willis gets it down. A very busy drive for Willis, and here's the touchdown. Very pretty over the top by Jaquez Parks, hooking up with Trey Willis to make it 14-7. Touchdown replays brought to us by our friends at the Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. And here's your scoring drive. 80 yards, took them only 5 plays, 93 seconds to make it 14-7. Two catches, 80 yards, instant results.
Now Griffin has to come down here and make some plays on the defense side of the ball.
Big hole up the middle. Trey Shivers cuts it back. Tackled crossing the 50. Special teams coming up now for Carrollton to give them another short field going up against the Griffin D.
Look at this hole right up the middle. You can just drive a straight truck between that hole right there. He has all the lanes in the world to choose from. Very nice run.
39 yards on the return for Trey Shivers. There's your interest. Cincinnati, Georgia Tech, Tennessee, among others. Going to be a very busy next couple of months for Trey Shivers, the way that he moves the football on offense and on special teams. Rolling out. One more time. Wide open over the top. Shivers caught. Touchdown. 48 yards. Carrollton responds in a hurry. Coming into the game, Will Garrett averaged 7 passes a game. They've already thrown it a handful of times, and each and every time it has caused headaches for Griffin, like this one.
Talk about a headache. What can't this young man do? He can run the football. You can definitely catch the football. And he plays special teams. It's been a one-man show tonight for Carrollton for Mr. Savage.
Touchdown replay brought to us by our friends at the Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. Newsom with the PAT makes it 21-7 Carrollton. Once again, a very busy drive. Here's the kickoff that set up his touchdown.
As you can see there, they know how to really utilize their players over at Carrollton, put them in the right position to succeed.
Garrett on the rollout over the top, just like Parks did on the drive before. One more look coming right into your living room.
And Trey only had 3 touchdowns going into this football game receiving. And he just added one more today.
14 on the ground this season, 3 through the air. And I think he's entitled to catch his breath for a little bit.
Yeah. I'm sure they're stacked over there like Nick Saban is at Alabama. Hey, come on, put my backup in, Coach. Come on, Coach, put my backup in. Let me catch my breath.
3-headed monster at running back. Trey Shivers, Jarvis Terrell, who's doing great things as a sophomore, and Malik Shepard. Tyler Newsom into the football one more time. He's going to be returned. 10, 15, 20. Around the corner, just outside the 30 to the 33-yard line. And once again, Griffin with great field position with Trey Willis. Both teams seeing action over the top with instant results in the passing game.
Passing game really is working. I guess just both teams is really expecting that. But let's take a look at this kickoff return. Special teams are going to play a big part of this football game, as it already has. But look at the blocking out front.
Devontae Freeman out front, Montico Dotson out front.
That's something you have to have. You have to be consistent with your blocking.
A lot of action going on out front. Parks decides to tuck and run. 40 with the stiff arm. Big block, and he clears the 45. That is protecting your quarterback. Brought to you by Christian Owens, and we'll see it at the end.
Once again, blocking plays another play in this football game, and you never, the play is not over until the whistle's blown. And every
7
little bit
dark. Why not one more from up top?
You just gotta love the game of football, man.
High snap on the next play. Parks looking to get rid of it, and he does. Very smart move. But they're calling a flag. Looks like they're going to call grounding on Jaquez Parks for trying to get rid of the football. Don't think he was outside the tackle box. And there's Steve DeVorsen saying he was outside the tackle box.
Did you see Griffin there? Trying to fight back for the momentum in this game here.
All right, let's take a look. Parks trying to create something. Throws it out of bounds. There's DeVorsen saying he was right here. There was a receiver right here for him.
That hurts him there, man.
takes them back all the way to the 21. So second down and 38, because it's 15 from the spot of the foul.
He's taking screens here, John.
27 yards on the penalty in total. Parks going to tuck it one more time. 25, 30, 35, 40. Breaks tackle, still on his feet, close to midfield.
His coach talked about his ability, too. He said, yeah, he has a really good arm, but one thing we really need him to do more is run the football, because he can get out of it. He's thinking pass, 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 and the last thing is on his mind is running. But tonight, he's definitely been putting his feet in action.
27-yard penalty, 26 yards coming back. Third down and 11, so it's third and manageable for Griffin and Jaquez Parks. Five in the pattern on third down. They have to get to the 42 of Carrollton for the first down, coming up on 100 seconds left first quarter. 21-7 over the top. One more time. Has the man caught. Foot race. Touchdown. One more time. Trey Willis. ...53 yards. Lob City working again for Griffin on the touchdown.
You can look what happens if you give the quarterback all the time in the world. It's again a mismatch on the outside. You're asking the receiver to cover you're asking the outside linebacker to recover a receiver. That's not going to happen. Not against Griffin, it's not. This Carrollton defense has to make some adjustments on the go, because Griffin's job is to move this ball down the field, and they're going to throw the ball, and that's their memo.
Parks holding for the PAT. PAT's up and good. 100 seconds left first quarter. And someone else who deserves to catch his breath a little bit is Willis. Let's look at the touchdown one more time. Up and over the top.
You think we found out who his favorite target is?
The one running down the seam. There's your scoring drive. Once again, brought to us by our friends at TCSG, Technical College System of Georgia. Learn more, earn more. 67 covered in three for 70 seconds. And this is what Griffin has done in their history. You see that 1978 state championship. They also won in 1942. First finals appearance since 1980, when they lost to Lowndes. 10-time semifinalist. Got their 12th region title in 2013. 13th straight playoff appearance in the record since 2004 under Steve Naborsny. A very solid 106-21.
It's one thing about this Griffin program. This town needs a win. They need a victory. You know, a lot of things going on with this community. You can just look, they traveled well. Look at the stands, they're up having a good time. And the coach talked about how, hey, this team desperately really needs something to happen. We need something good to happen for this community, and they're going to fight for it today.
Pooch thought about maybe catching him either off guard or onside. Carrollton hangs on to it, and they'll start at the Griffin 49.
This heads-up play by the cornerback.
Montezo.
Great job of, you know, 9 times out of 10 you can get the front man up in the front of the special teams. They're turning, trying to get their block. But sometimes you can catch them not paying attention, and I can understand why coach called that number.
Here's Garrett's numbers. So far, completed all of his passes for 82 yards. Inside handoff, nothing happening. Noah Clowers coming off the nose.
This is a very nice job by Noah Clowers, just using his hands to shade off the offensive lineman. As you can see him right there, getting down, getting low, and just making sure it happened. And also his man behind him, Tally Sloan, is getting it done, coming through, making those tackles in the backfield.
We said that Telly Sloan was going to have a busy night. We didn't know it was going to be this busy this early as we come up on 60 seconds for the first. And speaking of Telly Sloan, he just blew up the left-hand side of the Carrollton offensive line for the tackle for loss.
Just want to let you viewers know one thing about Sloan. He's a wrestler. He won second in state wrestling championships last year. Coach talks about he's just an old-school throwback guy. He does so much for this football club. He sells himself out every time. He's one of those leaders on this defense, and he's leading this team with 152 tackles on the season.
The belly to back suplex on Will Garrett, lost a yard. Looking outside, caught but out of bounds. You saw that statistic that we threw up at you. 330 plus yards in the first quarter alone. Here's one more look.
If you look at this, nice little safe rollout. As you can see, Sloan right there and is making the quarterback pay for it at the end. Every time you get a chance, you know, coaches always tell us, every time you get a chance to put the quarterback in the ground, you do it. And he meant it.
Telly Sloan with authority so far.
He has a great last name, too, man. It's a great football name, man.
Telly Sloan. Fake for Carrollton, man. Open, caught. The drive continues off the fake for the Trojans. Christian Ramirez with the completed pass to D'Antoine Cammons. And here's another look.
It's one of those young guys playing on the special team. Antoine used his numbers called. He's making it count. That's how you earn your stripes, man. You can see the punter right there. He's jumping up and down. He's fired up, man. Yeah, just made a completion. And that's what it's all about.
First pass attempt of the year off that kind of a fake punt. Puts Griffin back on their heels off the 27-yard completion. Back to the wing tee set. Jet sweep this side. Nothing happening. Big loss this time against the sophomore, Jarvis Terrell.
Jarvis Terrell getting his number called. He's trying to get a speed sweep across the middle. But there's no room for him to go. This defense of Griffin's finally just trying to step up and make a stop here and try to stop the bleeding.
Devontae Freeman lost his helmet. That meant the end of the play immediately. Nick Williams in on the tackle. 5 seconds to go here, first quarter, and it has been an eventful one, and that's kind of the understatement of the year. 5 scores in 12 minutes. And that'll do it for the first quarter. Back and forth, over the top. And let's see what the man in the white hat says. Is that the quarter? That is the end of the quarter. So, a lot of work over the top, passing game, a lot of offense from teams who've lit it up all season long. Continuing in game 15 in the Quad A Championship. A lot of action to come. 36 minutes to go to decide the Quad A champion. After one quarter at the Dome, it's Carrollton leading Griffin 21-14 on the Great GPB.
Are you getting ready to go to college? Do you need financial aid to help pay for your education? Visit gacollege411.org today and find the information you need to maximize your financial aid award. Learn about the many state financial aid programs the Georgia Student Finance Commission administers, including HOPE. Apply for federal and state student aid with the FAFSA and explore careers or find a college or technical school that fits your needs. Go to gacollege411.org today and expand your opportunities for tomorrow.
Hi, folks. Butch Miller from Milton Martin Honda in Gainesville, wishing you and yours a Merry Christmas and the happiest of New Year's. But if you think that the folks at Milton Martin Honda in Gainesville are proud to be supporters of Georgia high school athletics,
you got that right.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
You can't think about service in Georgia without thinking about our brave men and women in uniform. I'm here today with the Georgia National Guard, and we're very proud of them and their families and how they represent our state. At Georgia Farm Bureau, we're proud about the service we deliver to you and your family and to Georgia agriculture. We invite you to come to your local Farm Bureau office and join our family.
Take advantage of Farm Bureau's many services, from multi-line insurance to money-saving discounts. Visit us online at gfb.org.
Welcome back. Georgia Dome started the second quarter. If these two teams keep up their pace, they're slated for 140 points by the time the 48 minutes are complete. Here in the Class Quad A final, let's go downstairs to Grace Olson. Grace, what's up?
Thank you, John. Griffin has had 17 players move on to the NFL. So for tonight's trivia question, we're going to ask you about one of those. We want to know what former Griffin player won a Super Bowl ring with Mike Ditka's famous 1985 Chicago Bears. Find GPB Sports on Twitter. Find us on Facebook, whichever method you prefer, and let us know what you think the answer is. I'll return in the fourth quarter with our trivia winner for the night, who will also get to take home a GPB Football Fridays in Georgia t-shirt. John?
Thank you very much, Grace. And we will not be giving any hints. You're going to have to kind of find them. All right, there's a guy. So the tallest guy there on the Griffin sideline, the Jay Hay kid.
There
hanging
he is.
Out.
Hit stick, baby.
Jason Hayward hanging out with the folks on the Griffin sideline. There's a lot of royalty down there from what we understand. We'll be chasing after them as we go. Start of the second quarter. Garrett complete. Cole Cook, 22 yard line. Sorry, correction. Brandon Walton. This is the second time that Walton has been accessed in this game. Working the tight ends as well.
Yeah, Cole Cook bringing a lot to the table there. He's doing a really good job just making sure he gets out there to get that football in the open space and try to get a little bit as possible. Have 13 D1 offers tackled by Brandon Walton.
Third down four, so the catch gives you six. Let's see what the third and manageable is for Carrollton. Out of the wing tee. Inside handoff. Fake, nothing happening off the left guard. But with Jarvis Terrell getting the carry, putting it down fourth down and three, it's going to be something to think about. Noah Clowers right now down for Griffin. And that's the guy that runs the nose in this 4-3 defense for Griffin. And he's been involved in a lot of stuff. 65 tackles in the year, 8 tackles for loss, 4 sacks on the season, handful of hurries, and they're taking a look at him right now around the 20-yard line. So this presents a bit of an interesting question for Carrollton right now. On a 4th and 3 at the 17-yard line, you've got a great kicker in Tyler Newsom.
Yeah.
Heading to Notre Dame.
You got to kick the field goal here. You know, it's a state championship. Yeah, I know you made 6 points on the board. Looks a whole lot better than 3 points. But right now, the way Griffin is playing, you know, they can score very quickly.
All right, 53 right in the middle of it. And it looks like just in the defense, trying to stay on the nose, it looked like he got pushed back and got ground into the turf a little bit.
I'm telling you, man, this Griffin team, they spent some time in the weight room because I just saw what Sloan did to one of those offensive linemen. I tried to block him, man. He just moved him right out the way with no effort.
There's Ray Van Tee. And he's keeping the offense out on the field. Correction, Will Garrett. He's out there bringing in Newsom for the field goal attempt. Garrett will hold. Newsom will kick. 34-yard attempt is up, and he got it.
Has a monster.
Plenty
monster
of leg right there for Tyler Newsom downstairs, Raven Torado.
Guys, that Tyler Newsom kid that we just saw kick, I mean, definitely a heck of a kick right there. His coach said that he kicks 365 days a year. I know a kicker, and I have to say that's something special. They definitely put a lot behind their craft. Now, this kid, he said he's solid from 45, but he thinks that he can hit a 57-yarder. I'd love to see that tonight in this game. Back up to you, John.
Thank you very much, Raven. Raven knows her NFL kickers. That much is for sure. She knows what she's looking at when it comes to successful place kickers. There you go, Tyler Newsom. 6'2", 180, heading to South Bend. South Bend is getting a solid kicker. When you think about what Georgia has for kickers, always sending out a lot of kickers to great Division I programs. Newsom's the next one in that line.
You know, the work ethic that he has, and it's just top notch, man. You know, that's something that coaches just can't tell you over and over again. And you know, he's out there kicking by himself, as you see, as Raven told us. But just somebody who's jumping fence, and even when the gates are closed, he's jumping the fence just to kick some more on the holidays.
You know, Adam Griffith, folks saw, we've seen all year long at Alabama. Came from Calhoun. There's your scoring drive brought to us by our friends at the Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. 33 covered in 8, almost 3 minutes off the clock.
I remember the kickers at Georgia, man. They would come to the beginning of practice, kick for about maybe 10 minutes, then go in the locker room while everybody else is practicing and play video games, and then come back out the end of practice for the last 5 minutes of practice.
Park winding up, line up at the 35, down inside the 30. It's a foot race. Is he going to be caught? Answer, no. Touchdown, 80 yards, Keystone Fuller.
You guys better buckle up, because Griffin, they strike fast. This is what this makes this team so versatile. They have a quarterback that has a gun, and he can throw it anywhere and across the field that he wants. He's right on line with all his passes. He's precise. He stands in the pocket. He sets his feet. And most importantly, he has athletes around him that can catch the football and definitely can run with the football after the catch.
Minute 25 into the second quarter. We've had 10 points scored already. 24-21. Griffin coming back. Let's take another look at it. Walk me through it.
Oh, just look at the time he has. Jaquez Parks has had that time. He has a receiver down the field. It's basically on a wheel route. Kingston Fuller, his receiver, was lined up in the number two position. As you look at that, as you can see him there coming around, and just the cover two safety there just did not get over top and did not read the outside receiver. When you're in cover two, the worst route you can go against and the best route that you can run and the best play for is four verticals, and that's what they did on that play. And that stresses the safeties to get over and help two receivers.
I was going to say, this is looking like the SEC title game more than the Creekside Tucker game from last night. And it was that one had 80 total points. Right now, in 13 minutes and 25 seconds, we've already got 45 on the board.
You talk about that game, which was in this dome, his very own house.
Is there something in the water?
Hey, man, history repeats itself.
Pooch. 25-yard line picked up by Jarvis Terrell, runs into the pile. Ball on the floor. Who's got it? Scramble. There's a lot of folks down there. It's going to be the one who comes out at the bottom after they peel off all the bodies. Griffin saying they've got it. Carrollton naturally saying that they do.
I love it when the refs can't tell who has the ball.
Griffin being optimistic here.
That's the
effort. They're still scrapping for it.
That's the effort I'm talking about, man. This is the state championships, baby. You got to stay down in there and let them know you got the ball.
Griffin. All right, here's the end of the play.
You talk about special teams once again. I say, hey, this is going to be a big factor in this game. As you can see, number one coming on in there, knocking that ball out. Dante Freeman, the safety on the defense, who's one of their top players, who follows him in and puts his left hand in there and stripped that ball out of there. Great effort by Mr. Freeman.
Poke from behind. Momentum has swung for the second time in this game. Carrollton with their early scores.
Timeout, Griffin.
And Griffin, now that they've got momentum back, they're going to think about it.
I think that's a very smart move by with the head ball coaches. Just get his players, talk to them a little bit, calm them down. Just, you know, hey, guys, we got this under control. We're down a few points here. We can definitely put some more points on the board.
Here's the Griffins schedule, and a look at the offense that they've put up this year. Dutchtown, Northgate, Jonesboro, Woodland of Henry County, Stockbridge, consistently 30s, 40s, and 50s. Once they've gotten into the playoffs, it's 30s and 40s because we know that offenses and game plans kind of compress a little bit. Five shutouts The last one was against Rutland in the first round of the playoffs. Clamping down Statesboro 42-7, beating Sandy Creek. Then Wayne County, a very tough Wayne County team, making it to the semis.
And keep in mind, the most points any team ever scored on them is 35 points. And that was the first game of the season. So these guys, they do a really good job on the defense side of the ball. I'd like to see them wrap up and tackle a little bit better in the secondary, in the second half of their defense, because that's what wins championships.
Four wide in the pattern for Griffin. Minute 37 into the second quarter. High snap. Parks has to find it, and he does. Back at the 40.
Second time tonight with the high snap. If I'm Parks, I'm going over to my center, and I'm just going to whisper in his ear and say, "Hey, man, we've been working all year together. Let's not wait till the last game of the season to mess this one up."
Four wide once more for Griffin. Clock rolling. Better snap this time. Parks looking outside all by himself. Did he step out? That's the big question.
Yeah, they ruled that one incomplete. I think his left foot touched out of bounds.
So let's take a look. Quadius Weems.
Look at Mr. Weems here.
Parks looking at him the whole time.
Yeah,
foot's out of bounds before he caught it. Puts out of bounds before he caught it. Incomplete.
Third and long here. And we also know where's the mixed match too. I'm looking for number 8 and see where the linebacker's matched up on the outside.
Got to get to the 22 for a first down. Parks thinks about it. Tucks it. 30, 25. First down inside the 20.
Look at him go. Look at him go. Just a very nice job by Parks, standing up in the pocket. Good job by Carrollton by covering the receivers across the board. But Parks definitely has a motor on him, and he took it into his own hands on this play.
Carrollton sent 4, dropped 7. Parks outran them all for 22 yards, 65 yards so far. Quick out right there in the flat inside the 15. Hog collared around the 13-yard line was Trey Willis.
Talk about wrapping up. It's a real good job by the cornerback and also the wheel linebacker, Kay Crawford, making sure Trey Willis doesn't go for another touchdown.
3 minutes gone, second quarter. Griffin driving one more time. Parks thinking about it. Too much time to think. He's going to tuck it. Has a little room. Has a hole. 10. 5 inside the 5 to the 3. Gain of 10. Move the sticks.
As you see, Carrollton doing a really good job getting some pressure on Mr. Parks back there. But hey, one thing about an athlete is very hard to take somebody down who's determined, who has the willpower, who's the leader of this football team.
Escaping Cole Cook. Here's a look from the flip side. Gets out of the grasp once. Tucks it. And finally gets tackled at the 3.
Also getting a little aid by Dante Stanford, too. His right tackle.
And there's Devontae Freeman, who we expected to have a little action in the running game, taking time from defense. Gain of 2 out of their wing T formation, which you will see in closer formations. And that's their first rush.
And you can see these guys huddling up.
First rush for Devontae Freeman on the night.
You can see him huddling up. This team definitely doesn't huddle up often.
Parks not in the game, but the handoff is good. Touchdown for Griffin. Telly Sloan and the elephant back set up in their wing T. I guess the question is, what is it that Telly Sloan isn't going to do this evening?
Oh, man. He just won my heart.
He's
over.
Not quite a fridge. What's a smaller fridge?
I don't know the name for
handoff. Telly Sloan powers it through.
Oh, man.
Backup quarterback Anthony Stroud in there.
Quick story about Sloan here, too, as well. His coach talked about how everybody tries to stay away from him in practice. He's not allowed to participate in live drills because he's always hurting his teammates. Knocked out a few guys with concussions, too, as well. But good job with Sloan getting involved on the offensive side of the ball.
We think we figured it out. Telly Sloan, the cooler. In from the one, Griffin up 4, 28-24 in the second.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Want more joy this holiday?
Here's the season to be jolly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Proudly serving Georgia for over 40 years, with 83 locations across the state, Church's Chicken supports Georgia high school football on GPB and wishes all the teams good luck. Open before and after the game, it's Church's, where you always get more.
All purpose, Telly Sloan. He's in the backfield on defense. He's in the backfield on offense. Crashes in from the one. The cooler gives Griffin the lead.
Oh, man, one thing about this young man, what he's done on the defense side of the ball, he's very good. And you look at Parks here, just scrambling around, making things happen with his feet, especially on this drive. Hey, he's always thinking pass first. That's one thing that his coach said. He spends a lot of time in the film room. He does a really good job going through his progressions. But he said, we really need him to run a little bit more. Tonight, he's definitely done a really good job of running the football because this Carrollton defense playing the receivers halfway decent when he doesn't have time in the pocket.
I can't take all the credit. Kevin Barnes, our eye up here, gets credit for calling him the cooler from this moment forward. Here's your scoring drive brought to us by our friends at the Technical College System of Georgia. TCST, learn more, earn more. 32 for 7 takes up 228. 300 total yards of offense, 303 total yards for Jaquez Parks on 7 carries and 6 passes. Touched it, but it's knocked out of bounds at the 33. Carrollton starts again, down 4. So let's see what Carrollton can do to respond. They had the momentum early in the first. Griffin has had the momentum here in the second. 52 points on the board in about 17 minutes of action.
But here's the thing for Carrollton. They have to get back into the groove of what they do best, John. Running the football, giving the football to multiple guys. I really like on the first drive, they did a nice run-pass balance to keep this defense honest. If they can continue to keep doing that and get back to what really got them to this point, you can probably see another 7 points on the board before halftime.
Jet sweep Terrell cuts it back inside, gets it close to the 50. Gain of 15 out to the 47.
As you can see here, this is another sweep on the outside. Kind of fools our camera guy as well. You planted that left foot and get upfield. Those are things about those speed sweeps. If they're all the running backs is doing, it's designed for them to cut back and find a running lane.
Nick Williams trying to grab a hold of Jersey there. Keeps the game at just 12. Inside handoff. Gets it into Griffin territory for another 12-yard run. Trey Shivers that time. And we talked about Carrollton coming at you in waves, whether it's Shivers number one, Jarvis Terrell number two, Malik Shepard number three. Quarterback Will Garrett has even done the keeper a couple of times.
You can see he's very, very good with his eyes. He makes right decisions with his feet to cut back in certain lanes. Young man's coming in this football game with 1,600 yards, all-purpose yards.
Shivers averaging 14 yards a carry. Dive. Nothing happened there.
Look who it is.
It's the cooler.
And it's open today, baby. The cooler is not closed. This is the open.
Malik Shepard getting nothing.
You see him coming up, making his reads. He's playing inside out. As a linebacker, you definitely have to. You don't never want to overrun the running back. You don't want to overrun your blocking scheme because that's when the running back can definitely cut back on you.
Six tackles, 2 for loss. Jet sweep bounced off his own left guard and tackle. Terrell gets more positive yards, takes it close to the 35.
Sloan on another touchdown saving tackle there. See him just roving over, taking on a block.
Ready to launch on anybody. Gets off the block of the lineman. A great ankle tackle that time by Telly Sloan. Those eyes look like Mike Singletary of the Chicago Bears. And he's hitting like him too. Play action. Garrett trying to go over the top. Throws it off his back foot. Not enough on it. Underthrown but caught. Andrew Turner with the catch. Garrett creating something out of a lot of traffic in front of him. Takes it inside the 10.
As you can see here, to give him Garrett some time in the pocket. You see what he really does. You know, he's just throwing up for a hope and a pair. And his receiver just did a really good job. Andrew Turner just running up under it.
Underthrown off the back foot. Comes in with the catch for 29 yards. First and goal from the 8. Coming up on 5.5 to go here. First half. Wing T set from Carrollton. Motion near side. Handoff to Shivers. Bounces off the first tackle. Takes it down to about the 6. Short yardage gain there on first down.
Is this a very nice athletic move by Andrew Turner? Just coach say he plays center field on a baseball team, and sometimes when we need big plays, we'll throw the ball up there to him, and he'll just run up under it. He'll find some way to find the ball. Runs a 4.5 40. Blocks well. He's the go-to guy in the passing game.
Incidental face mask on the defense. 5-yard penalty, half the distance from the end of the run. Replay first down.
So they'll take the penalty down to the 3-yard line. Quick setup for Carrollton, trying to retake the lead. Motion. Terrell caught in the backfield. Ball is loose. Griffin's got it. And they're not down yet. Looks like Griffin has a convoy coming back the other way. It's going to be Griffin for the score. Ryan Cochran, unless he runs out of gas. And he makes it. Touchdown, 90 yards. Ryan Cochran. Just when Carrollton thought they were going in for the game-leading score, Griffin steals momentum back from them again.
You talk about a defense of goal line stand. I haven't seen something like this in years. And the effort of Ryan just keeping his feet, keeping his hand off the ground. And look at the combo out in front blocking for him. You talk about a team effort. In the state championship here in the dome, when you get a chance to score on defense here, John, look out. He's laid out on the bench there. I'm tired, guys.
He is spent.
He's going to remember that play for the rest of his life.
Point after spot kick. And pull hook goes through. Talk about someone who deserves a bit of a blow. It's going to be Ryan Cochran. Let's take another look at it. Looked like they were trying to do the crisscross handoff again. The runners met. Ball popped into the air. Great presence of mind by Cochran to pick it up. And he had 3 guys going with him down the sidelines. And it looked like Cochran about the 15 was wondering. And he got it.
And there's, who it is.
There's the cooler. Creating havoc. Everyone looking for him.
The cooler wanted to grab the ball and lay on the ball. But Ryan was like, no, man, I'm trying to run with it.
But then we get to the 15. Am I going to get there? It looks like he did.
And you look at this crowd. We talk about this community. They're here supporting their sons out there on the football field.
Take a deep breath, young man. You've earned it.
He was. Did you see him laid out on the bench there? He was gassed.
The tank wasn't on E for empty. It was down around D or C. He was that spent.
And the cooler's just showing no emotion. He's not high-fiving
anybody.
Still
a business trip.
he's not slapping nobody up top, no down low. He's just like, okay, I know I got to go back on this football field.
For for Griffin on the kick, picked up at the 28. Running far side, hole 35, out past the 40. So Carrollton starting the 41-yard line, under 5 minutes to go. 59 total points have been scored in just over 17 minutes of action.
Here's the key, John. Defense scored on defense, run down there on a very exciting play. But guess what? They got to go right back out there on the very next play. So expect something from Carrollton to catch these guys off guard because they just ran 90 yards. Emotions are high, and that's why the cooler, he was not too excited about that. He said, hey, guys, we got to go back out here and stop these guys. It's almost 5 minutes left on the clock.
The bigger question is Ryan Cochran out there right now. The answer is no. He's getting a bit of a blow. Right guard and tackle past the 45, still grinding out to the 48-yard line.
He does a great job.
Trey Shiver.
He does a great job keeping his legs moving. It's very hard to take down a skilled running back. Running backs are tall. Drive your legs. Keep your legs moving. Even if you feel like you're going down, because that one time that you just give up with your leg, that 1 yard, you probably could have kept going and got us a first down. He does a really good job with his legs.
Now let's see what Will Garrett can do. Coming up on 4 minutes to go, first half. 59 points on the board. Carrollton looked like they were going to punch it in for the lead. They're down 11 instead. And it's going to be close to the first down. Downstairs, Raven Tirado. Raven, what's up?
John, number three that just scored that touchdown, he's not the cooler, but he goes by Wawa. His real name is Ryan Cochran, and he's a junior, being very effective in the state championship game tonight. Back up to you, John.
And in the honor of the holiday season, I guess it's fa-la-la-la-la,
la-la-la-la. Yeah, he's got to go out there and do it again consistently. You got a whole nother half of football to play, Wawa.
Jet sweep, far side, left guard and tackle, gets about a yard or two.
It's a good
Jarvis
job.
Terrell there that time.
Good job by the outside linebacker. Nick Williams is coming up. Guy who has a 111 tackles. Great speed. Six sacks on a football season. He has his hands full, because when you're playing that outside linebacker position, you have to scrape up and take on those offensive tackles and make tackles at the same time.
Power right, two wide receivers up top for Carrollton. Play action, Garrett thinking about going over the top. He's going to tuck it. No room, but he tucks it anyway. Gets it just past the 45. Down to the 44. Maybe a gain of three, possibly four, to create third down, third and five for Carrollton. And once again, clugging the holes, Ronquavius Davis, among others.
They call him the sap. Since we're getting into nicknames, this is somebody who has a motor, who they coach talking about how everybody wants to really, you know, give him compliments, and it reminds him of Warren Sapp, the Pro Bowler, the Hall of Famer. He's a four-year starter, someone who's the middle of this defense in the heart and soul, and knows everything about this Griffin program.
And that caused the jump, the motion that time by Trey Shivers. Neutral zone violation. That's going to get him a first down. Here's the official call.
Dead ball, encroachment on the defense, 5 yard penalty.
And that's a way to get a first down when you want to keep a drive alive, heading up on 2 minutes to go. And there's Coach Dvorsny pleading his case, saying that Carrollton shifted. Motion by Trey Shivers, center moving forward. Ray Van Teek trying to get another score on the board. He's proven that he's been able to move the ball on Griffin. Down 11, trying to trim it. Gonna have a Tyler Newsom field goal, cut it to eight, another touchdown, which is what he wants in this tennis match. Get points on the board, ball on the ground again. They didn't get it. So this presents an interesting question.
Oh, they gave it to him, John.
Big spot. Big spot inside the 39. They give him forward progress to the flip side of the 39-yard line.
We got to look at this offensive line for Carrollton. The big guys up front, number 78.
And here's your look.
And they're following those guys up front.
Looks like he got to the 38. Jet sweep, run. to the 35, so that's three. Coming up on 80 seconds to go, first half. Jarvis Terrell that time.
Jarvis Terrell, someone who's a sophomore in this program, who grew up in this program, was an eighth grader who just did so much for the program, and he was over 1,000 yards as an eighth grader. And they said, hey, look, man, we just got to move this guy up. Someone who runs a 4-4, 40-yard dash. He runs a 10-6-7 in the 100 meters, too, as well. This guy, he brings a lot to the table, and that's their second go-to guy.
Garrett, pump fake over the top, in and out of the hands. Andrew Turner had it, couldn't hang on to it. There's a flag at 46 seconds. Here's another look.
You see this double move. You try to get stop and go, and the cornerback, I think the cornerback just did a really good job, but he didn't turn his head around. That's one thing that you really have to do. You can shield the receiver and keep him from running his route, but you have to look back for the football. That's why that play was a flag.
Let's get the call.
Pass interference on the defense. 15-yard penalty on the previous spot. Result of play, first down.
Another first down by penalty on this drive. Montavious Brown was guarding Andrew Turner on the way down on that far sideline. Here's Coach Dvorsny one more time talking to the officials. 46 seconds to go, first half. Over 400 yards of offense shown by teams that have been able to put it up in bunches this season. Three receivers. Motion to the bottom. Jet sweep coming through. Big cut. Back inside 15 down to the 10. Jarvis Terrell getting yards. Close to a first down. Let's see where the spot is.
One thing you cannot.
First down call.
One thing you cannot do is dive at somebody's feet right there. You got to go tackle them five. You got to go get them. You got to bring your eyes. You got to bring your feet. You can't hit what you can't see.
Terrell bouncing off folks, including Telly Sloan, getting it to a first and goal situation. Three wide for Carrollton. Quick screen back to the 12, 10, and they're going to keep the clock going. Say he didn't get out of bounds in time. Ball at the 6, complete to Jarvis Terrell. We're going to call a timeout now at 16 seconds.
Just a very nice job by the Sam linebacker number two out there in coverage. Georgian cover this on the outside. You see the hitch route going straight here. He's going to try to get it out to him. He comes up and make this tackle inside out. Pressing the outside shoulder. It's a really good job by the cornerback making that tackle.
There's been a lot of stuff to talk about in this game. 59 points on the board, so why not do it through social media? GPB is all over social media. Check us out on Facebook and Twitter and on Instagram. Be a part of the GPB Sports family. Follow us throughout the day to see interviews with fans, parents. Check out the couch gating. Check out the cool fan pictures. Posting them all day long. Be a part of the process. Follow GPB Sports now. So during the off season, you can keep up with everything that is going on in all of high school sports, from who's going where on National Signing Day to leading up to the basketball championships and Macon Madness and beyond. Like and follow us now, GPB Sports on Facebook, Instagram, and at GPB Sports on the Twitter machine.
Speaking of that app, John, you know, we're covering the state playoffs every Friday night. How useful was that app for you to keep up with those scores? Because we tossed down to the sideline too.
Huge.
Quite a bit.
Huge. Twitter, Facebook, the app. It's what it's all about. To keep up with everything going on at GPP. 16 seconds, probably time for two plays. The Carrollton has timeouts. Garrett rolling out, looking, far end zone, incomplete.
Carrollton trying to roll out and make something happen on the wide side of the field. This Griffin defense going to man-to-man on the outside, hat for a hat. Just didn't have anything there.
Garrett winds up and throws. So far, 7-9 for 125 yards through the air. 11 seconds. Another quick pass play, so it's like a play and a half, even though you've got a timeout and you've got two timeouts. You can do something to the middle of the field if you need to. Fade pattern, jump ball to the big tight end. It was caught, but Griffin called a timeout before the play went off. Griffin calls timeout.
Griffin.
Their last of the half.
I like that idea. They had the right matchup on the outside, but coach called the timeout. He must have saw exactly what the offensive coordinator saw, and he got the timeout in time.
When you've got big tight ends like Brandon Walton and Cole Cook, easy to throw the fade to the big 6'6 kids.
You had Montavious Brown on the outside, who's 5'6", 160 pounds. You got to like your chances.
Please reset the clock.
But hey, don't get it twisted. He has 5 interceptions on the year and leading this football team too, coming into this football game. So he's a good athlete as well.
So Ray Van Teague has 2 timeouts. You can work something to the middle of the field quickly, because remember, all you need is 6 yards to get a touchdown on the board.
If you've
got a good kicker in Tyler Newsome,
right,
also in case it doesn't work on third down, so you can get some points on the board before you head into the locker room.
All coach did is go over there and tell these guys, hey, it's all about technique on this play. This is a big third down, 11 seconds. You want to stop these guys going into halftime. Make sure you pay attention to your keys. And they really like to run a lot of crossing routes, misdirectional plays on the Carrollton side of the offense. So I wouldn't be surprised if Griffin go man-to-man across the board.
Look to the fade, looked off, incomplete. One more time, fourth down.
You definitely have to go for 3 right here. You have the best kicker in the country, in my opinion. He's been automatic for them all year, headed to Notre Dame. Go ahead and get your 3 points, coach, and count your blessings until the halftime.
Newsome makes it. He's only down by 8. And for a right-footed kicker, this should be just a bit of a punch shot. 23-yard attempt. Snap, spot, kick is true. Ray Van Teague getting points on the board. 6 seconds to go here before halftime. So Tyler Newsome is going to probably squib it down the field. And Griffin could have one more shot. And by the way, if you haven't heard, we have a fantastic high school sports football app. You're never away from all the live action during championship weekend. You can watch the games on the app if you wander away from your television. Every game live from your iPhone or iPad, no matter where you go this weekend or for the entire football season, the entire high school football season. Take us along. Watch every high school football game live on GPP. Check the latest scores. By the way, it's free. Download it from the App Store today.
You know, I have to, you got to tip your hands off to this Griffin's defense going down there for the second time in a row, having a very nice stand. You know, you survived 3 points, Carrollton, but for the defense, that's a win.
Newsome will kick it deep and it'll start at the 20. So it'll be interesting to see. Griffin takes a shot, or if they're just going to take a knee, up 8.
I can hear that kick when he put his foot on the ball. You can
Thunderfoot.
You can hear that thump all the way from up here, baby.
Mm-hmm. Scoring drive brought to us by our friends at TCSG, the Technical College System of Georgia. Learn more, earn more. 53 yards, taken up in 11 plays. 4:41 off the clock, 3 points on the board. 62 points on the board in this first half.
Griffin's going to just take a knee here and run the clock out. Take it on in for halftime.
Shotgun, thought about doing something, nothing happening, and that'll do it. If I told you that at the half we would be 35-27, what would you have said?
No way.
That's what we got. Send it downstairs to Raven Tirado with Griffin head coach Steve Dvorsny. Raven.
Thanks, guys. Coach, I saw you not talk to the ref once, but twice in the last 40 seconds. What was the discussion there?
Just let them know they can throw a flag on them one time, too. We're getting a bunch of them. I just want to feel good tonight and let them get one.
The scoring, the wide open playing that's going on. Have you ever been a part of anything like this?
Come again?
The wide open scoring that's going on, the, I guess, shootout, you could say.
Yeah, I mean, that's having fun.
Definitely. Let me ask you this last question. Going in the second half, what will be the deciding factor for Griffin if they can come out on top?
Well, I mean, you know, turnovers has been big, you know, early in this game already, and, you know, field position, that their kicker, he's doing a good job tonight for them. So we just got to hopefully keep the ball, keep scoring, and, you know, hopefully we can come out with a win.
Good luck, Coach.
Thank you.
Back over to you, Mark.
Thanks very much. Coming up on our GPB halftime show, we'll have all the scores coming up from championship weekend. Plus, John Nelson visits some back roads and backfields where we learn a lesson on the value of dedication.
Also, Grace Olson is going to check in with some proud parents, and she's going to share the latest about what's going on online. That's all coming up in the GPB halftime show. Do not change that channel.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
It's been said that championships aren't won by individuals. They're won with team and teamwork. Hi, I'm Zippy Duval, president of Georgia Farm Bureau, and we're proud of our partnership with Georgia High School Association Athletics. In all of our county farm bureaus across the state, we have a championship team ready to deliver services to you and your family and all of Georgia farmers across this state. We invite you to come to your local county farm bureau and be part of our team. Go team!
Visit us online at gfb.org.
Welcome back to Chance of a Lifetime. It's the final stage of the game, and it's also time for Jane to choose a door. Help her out. What door should she pick? All right, so Jane, which door did you choose?
I think I'm going to go with door number two.
Door number... Oh, wait a minute. It looks like it says right here that you never graduated high school, so none of these doors are available to you. That's it for Chance of a Lifetime. We'll see you next time.
I can't believe it's time to think about taxes already.
It's time to donate your vehicle to GPB. The end of the year is here. 877-472-1227 or online.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
As the demand for power grows,
Georgia's nonprofit,
member-owned electric cooperatives
are committed to providing safe,
affordable,
and reliable electricity
to our members.
We've been dedicated
to building strong
communities
for more than 70 years
and are proud to join
the Georgia High School Association
and Georgia Public Broadcasting
in support of our state's student athletes.
We are Georgia EMC, lighting the way.
Are you getting ready to go to college? Do you need financial aid to help pay for your education? Visit gacollege411.org today and find the information you need to maximize your financial aid award. Learn about the many state financial aid programs the Georgia Student Finance Commission administers, including HOPE. Apply for federal and state student aid with the FAFSA and explore careers or find a college or technical school that fits your needs. Go to gacollege411.org today and expand your opportunities for tomorrow.
Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. Welcome back to GPB. Welcome back to Championship Weekend. We are at the half of the 4A Championship game. The Griffin Bears leading the Trojans of Carrollton 35-27 in one of the best first halves that we have seen this weekend. It was a barn burner kind of first half.
It is. I kind of feel bad for the guys upstairs who have to update the scoreboard because they are not getting any rest during this game.
No. The stat guys, too, are busy.
Oh, yeah, they are. But one of the great things is we have been seeing people all weekend long who are not able to make it here to the Dome, but they want to support their team, and so they are doing it in a very special way, something we like to call couch gating. So let's check in with Grace Olson. She's been checking in with those couch gaters all day long. Grace?
Thank you, Claire. Our fans have been loving that couch gating. We have a photo album going on our Facebook page, the GPB Sports Facebook page. You have to like us to see it, and we're uploading all of our fans' couch gating photos. They're watching in across all the way across Georgia, across the country, across the world, and we have all the photos and the captions up on that album on our Facebook page, so make sure to like us on Facebook to see that. Now, we also have albums going for every single game throughout the finals, so if you like us on Facebook, you can find all that awesome stuff. Maybe find somebody that you know was at the games. Tag yourself, tag your friends, and also we're not just covering the state finals. We cover high school sports all throughout the year. Signing day, high school basketball, we've got it going all year long. So if you like us on Facebook, you can stay updated on all your fabulous high school sports. Back to you, Claire.
Thank you so much, Grace. I'd like to now welcome in a very special guest. This is the principal of Carrollton High School, Mark Albertus. Thank you for being here.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
Now, did you expect to see a game like this?
Well, we knew it would be a good one, but this is sure a shootout.
It so definitely is.
We've got our money's worth here with this game, and we've still got a second half to play. So we're excited about it and excited about being here.
All right, it is time to play everybody's favorite game. You know, we're putting the football players to the test. We're going to put you to the test as well. There's the question. I'll have you hand it to me. We're going to test and see, are you smarter than your students? Here's the question. The caber toss is a sport played during which Scottish event? Is it A, the Highland Games, B, Oktoberfest, C, El Nino, or D, Catch the Haggis?
How about A, Highland Games?
Ding, ding, ding. You are correct. That is a very good job. Thank you for being here.
Thank you,
ma'am. Good
luck
to your team in the second
half.
Thank you. All right, Mark?
I wonder what catching the haggis is all about. Well, that might be kind of fun to play. High school football games have great entertainment at halftime. The marching bands are part of the great pageantry. And let's check in now with the Carrollton Marching Band, brought to you by Regions Bank. Great job by the Carrollton Marching Band, brought to you by Regions Bank. Now coming up, John Nelson digs in for details on Griffin's unbeaten season, and we'll hear from the Griffin Marching Band as well.
Plus, Grace Olson is going to give some parents a chance to check in on their skills. We're going to have also a little bit more on social media, what's going on with our Couch Gators at home, that and much more ahead on GPB.
Hi folks, Butch Miller from Milton Martin Honda in Gainesville, wishing you and yours a Merry Christmas and the happiest of New Year's. But if you think that the folks at Milton Martin Honda in Gainesville are proud to be supporters of Georgia High School Athletics,
you got that right!
You have to seize any advantage you can get to build a career, even while you're still in high school. That's why the Technical College System of Georgia offers dual enrollment. You earn college and high school credit at the same time, saving you money on college tuition. It's about your future. Dual enrollment jumpstarts your college education and prepares you for work in exciting career fields. Talk to your parents, school counselor, or a TCSG college about dual enrollment, or go to tcsg.edu.
Still to come on this season of Georgia Traveler, I feel the need for speed.
I tell you what, that was incredible.
Welcome to Pasaquan. Here goes nothing.
That is all goodness. Really, really good.
All I can say is, it was doggone fun. Seriously.
Class, brass, and a whole lot of sass. The Morehouse Jazz Ensemble.
All that and more coming soon on Georgia Traveler.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Developing leaders for Georgia agriculture is very important to us at Georgia Farm Bureau. Hi, I'm Zippy Duval, president of Georgia Farm Bureau. Just like high school athletics, it develops leaders for our community and our state. We at Georgia Farm Bureau think it's just as important to develop the future leaders of Georgia agriculture. Our national security depends on it.
Take advantage of Farm Bureau's many services, from multi-line insurance to money-saving discounts. Visit us online at gfb.org.
Welcome back to the 2013 GHSA Battle Champ Football Championships Halftime Show live on GPB. We're in the midst of the 4A championship game between Griffin and Carrollton. The Bears leading the Trojans 35-17 as the Battle Hymn of the Republic wraps up the Carrollton band performance. They did a great job tonight.
They did. They sound amazing. I mean, sitting here down the field, it's like, whoo, yeah, we're right there.
Very loud.
It is. Now it is time to put another principal in the hot seat for everybody's favorite game, Are You Smarter Than Your Students? Joining me now is Keith Simmons from Griffin High School. And, we're a little early on that, but that's all right. You told me that you barely have a voice.
That's correct.
Everybody at home can hear that. You're just so excited. Tell me about what it's been like to be here at this game.
This has been a great experience for our school, our community, our students and players. 35 years in the waiting, and we've enjoyed this past week. The students have shown a lot of energy. Extremely proud of our students, our coaches, our players. It's a good time at Griffin High School in Griffin, Spalding County.
All right, now we're going to play the game. We've got the question in hand. Our theme tonight is sports, so we're going to test you and see how much you know.
Okay.
All right, here's the question. Mushing refers to any sled-based sport powered by what? Is it A, reindeer, B, dogs, C, children, or D, carnies?
Let me think on that for a second. I think it's B, dogs.
You're right. You are smarter. You have outsmarted our sports trivia tonight. And I hope you continue to scream as loud as you have
Same
been
here.
For the second half. Thanks for being
me.
Here. All right, Mark, over to you.
There are a lot of Carrollton and Griffin fans that are a little bit hoarse tonight. Great game, great first half. Georgia EMC scoreboard now on tap. We're going to check out all the scores from all the games from this year's GHSA Championships. First one was yesterday in the 1A private school, and that was won by Aquinas, beating Calvary Day 27-7. And the 3A champs are Buford again this year. They beat Washington 35-19. The 5A Tucker game was also a shootout as Creekside beats the Tigers 52-28. In the 1A public school game today, it was Marion County winning over Charlton County 12-3. It is the 2A champion is Lovett as they beat Lamar County by a touchdown 14-7. At the half right now, a wild shootout as Griffin leads Carrollton 35-27. And we've got another big game coming your way tonight around 8:30, the 6A game. Region 7 rivals North Gwinnett and Norcross will kick it off around 8:30 or so. Now let's check in with the sounds of the Griffin Marching Band, brought to you by Regions Bank. School Band of Gold, the drum major, I'm told by Claire, is just 9 years old. Wow, that is great. That is talent in the making. Time now for our back roads and backfield segment, brought to you by the Georgia Farm Bureau. For this one, we go up to the broadcast booth to John Nelson, who has the story of this year's Griffin Bears. John?
Thank you very much, Mark. Griffin's only 24 minutes away from getting their first state title since 1978. They've always gone deep into the playoffs, but they've never made it back to a game 15. And sometimes it's the simplest act that can get you as close as you want to a title.
There's always that moment, the moment when things come together. The time you spend together as a team is different. It just feels different. The focus is different and sharper. Motivation is forward toward a singular goal. And that's what it's like watching the Griffin Bears. By their own admission, this visible and tangible change happened in the offseason.
We used to not hold each other accountable, and that was last year, and our team just crumbled apart. And when we started holding each other accountable back in January of last year, when we started lifting weights for this coming up season, you could see a different formation in the team, that you could see everybody gelling together, everybody wanting to be a part of something of what we got, because everybody knew this was going to be the year that something special would happen.
Yeah, I could tell that everybody they stepped it up this year and they really wanted it, because they were like working hard in the weight room and everybody was focusing and coming a lot this summer. We didn't have a lot of people miss days. And I could just tell in everybody's mind that they really wanted it.
And having what could be the Quad A Player of the Year in your quarterback, it has proven and produced dividends. The last time the Bears were this deep, 1980, when they lost the championship game to Lowndes. But have these results surprised them so far this year? Depends on which age group you ask, really.
Pretty much coming into this year, I expected us to have a good team, and I expected us to go this far. I had no doubt that we would be able to accomplish the things we've accomplished so far.
We felt like we could be explosive on both sides of the ball this year, because we do have speed and some talented kids. But, this year has been special, and, hopefully we continue that.
And hopefully, Mark, they will continue that. All the Griffin Bears fans, one simple act, holding each other accountable, and that's a great thing to see for 15 to 18-year-old men to do that as they work forward toward one goal.
All right, John Nelson, thank you very much with another great edition of Back Roads and Backfields brought to you by the Georgia Farm Bureau. Claire?
All right, guys, it's time to check in with a segment we called Rent Check. Our Grace Olson is standing by with not just Rent Check, but Rent Check Family Edition.
Ready? That's right. We're checking in with some parents here and sister and seeing how well they know their son. I've got Monica, Marco, and Jaden Colbert, the family of Jordan Colbert Griffins Jr. Now, let's bring up a photo first. You told me Jordan was about 7 months old in this photo. What a cute kid. Looks like he's posing pretty well for a 7-month-old.
Yeah, and once he started playing football, he had a tendency to pose for pictures, and they started calling him Hollywood. But his coach, the late Willie Lewis, told him, if you're going to call yourself Hollywood, you need to make plays. And ever since then, he's been making plays.
Looks like that's been a good thing for him. So his nickname is Hollywood. Now let's get down to some trivia. First question is for you, Mom. What is Jordan's favorite subject in school?
I'm going to say math.
Math, quick one. You got it right. Thank you, Dad. Second question for you. What is Jordan's favorite pregame meal?
Anything with ranch, but if I had to say Chick-fil-A.
Chick-fil-A, you're right. Jaden, let's ask you one. You want to answer a question? You don't? Okay, well, let's go back to Mom. What is Jordan's dream job?
He said he wanted to work in communications.
He wants to play in the NFL. And Dad, last one's for you. Favorite or least favorite chore?
Anything involving cleaning up.
Doing the dishes. Thank you so much for joining us on Rent Check. Here's your Football Fridays in Georgia t-shirt. I'm going to send it back over to Claire on the stage.
Thanks so much, Grace. They certainly know Jordan. Now it's time for our career play of the game, presented by the Technical College System of Georgia. The healthcare field is broad and full of rewarding careers. Medical and clinical lab tech jobs are growing at a rate of over 2% annually. Jobs in biotechnology labs are growing at about the same rate as Georgia continues to compete in high-paying science and technology fields. Other areas of healthcare, like pharmacy technology, have provided stable jobs for a long time. Even working as a veterinary tech can be a rewarding way to make a living. That's why healthcare is back in the spotlight as our career play of the game. This message is brought to you by the Technical College System of Georgia. To get more information about the Technical College System, you can visit their website at tcsg.edu. Mark?
We are getting ready for the second half of this game, the 4A championship game between Griffin and Carrollton. But before we kick things off, we want to tell you about a way you can show your appreciation for high school football on GPB. You can text a $10 donation to help keep programming like this on the air. All you have to do is text the letters GPB to the number 85944. Be sure to reply yes, and message and data rates may apply. You ready for the second half?
Oh, my gosh. I don't know. I don't know if the scoreboard operators are ready for the second half, but I guess it's going to come whether we're ready or not.
Right. They may be cramping up. We've got Carrollton, and we've got Griffin coming up next.
All right. Let's send it back upstairs to our own John Nelson and Keelan Johnson. Guys, take it away.
Thank you, Claire. We're going to see if the second half holds true to your prediction. 62 points on the board. How many more are scored in the final 24 minutes? The Quad A title hangs in the balance on the great GPB.
The wheels of progress haven't been very active lately. But because of business people like you, things are beginning to get rolling. And Regions is here to help, making it easier with the expertise and service to keep those wheels turning. From business loans to cash management, we want to be your partner moving forward. Let's get going together.
Are you getting ready to go to college? Do you need financial aid to help pay for your education? Visit gacollege411.org today and find the information you need to maximize your financial aid award. Learn about the many state financial aid programs the Georgia Student Finance Commission administers, including HOPE. Apply for federal and state student aid with the FAFSA and explore careers or find a college or technical school that fits your needs. Go to gacollege411.org today and expand your opportunities for tomorrow.
During this performance, one student will drop out of high school. Be there for your big finish.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
This program on GPB is made possible in part by supporters of the Georgia High School Association, including the following.
Animal agriculture is important to Georgia. Our farmers work hard each and every day to take care of our animals across this state. Hi, I'm Zippy Duval, president of Georgia Farm Bureau, and we're proud of our partnership with Georgia High School Association. Just as we teach our children to work hard and accomplish goals, we take care of each other like a family. We as farmers across this state love our animals, and we work hard to take care of them too, don't we, Jim?
Visit us online at gfb.org.
Welcome back, Georgia Dome. Second half getting ready for the Quad A final, and I've wanted to say this all weekend. Downstairs to Raven with Ray-Van.
How'd I know you were going to do that, John? Anyway, Coach, defensively, what adjustments did you make at halftime?
Well, bottom line is we've just got to put our eyes on the right person. We got caught twice in man-to-man coverage and didn't keep up with our man. And then the one time we were in cover two and the corner put his eyes in the backfield and the kid ran by him. So we just got to read our keys and do what we've been taught to do all week long.
Absolutely. I know we talked a little about this before we got on camera, but did you expect this when you were preparing for this game?
No, we normally play good defense. Right now we're not doing that.
All right, Coach. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
All right, John, back to you.
Thank you very much, Raven, with Ray-Van. And I think we're going to have a couple of touchdowns to show here for first half highlights.
We definitely going to have a few touchdowns.
I think we have eight. And let's go ahead and show you what happened here in the first half. Trey Shivers.
As you can see, Trey Shivers just doing it, making it happen with his vision and also making it happen with his feet. And also Griffin just bouncing back. This team can score at any given time and any given moment. And that's what's been going back and forth. Somebody on the defense side of the ball has to step up. Special teams have been huge in this football game. It's going to come down to those two type of plays.
There's Jaquez Parks, who had a big first half over the top. Trey Willis, busy night for him. Caught one at 30 and one at 53.
He has so many attributes. He has so many weapons around him. That's what makes this offense works. You heard the coach talked about we messed over on turnovers. We didn't play well on the defense side of the ball. But this is the X factor. Them scoring on defense, them taking the momentum back and running the ball down the field 90 yards. Ryan Cahoon.
There's Ryan making it, crashing into the end zone. Let's take a look at those first half stats. Brought to us by our friends at Church's Chicken Stats, courtesy of the West Georgia Technical College. What stands out for you other than the 542 yards of total offense?
You know what stands out to me? The two turnovers that Carrollton has.
Okay.
Because Griffin maximized those turnovers. They scored on those turnovers. They took a fumble 90 yards to the house. When you can score on the defense side of the ball, that makes all the difference in the world. When anytime you can help your offense out, makes everything easy for you.
Carrollton averaging 5 yards a play on the ground. Griffin averaging 12 yards a play, period. So let's take a look at the second half and see what happens here. We figured that this was going to be a game where a lot of points were scored. We just didn't figure all of them were going to be scored in the first half as we rival the SEC title game here. What was the final there?
Oh, man, it was a high-scoring game.
It was 49-32. Does that sound close?
There's no defense played in that game, I'll just tell you that.
So we'll see what happens here in the next 24 minutes. The Quad A title to be decided. Last title for Carrollton, 1998, when they defeated Early County. Last appearance in a championship game a couple of years back, when they lost on a heartbreaking fumble as they were driving for the game-tying score against Sandy Creek. Last appearance in a title game for Griffin, 1980, lost to Lowndes. Last championship, 1978, in a 7-7 tie with Valdosta. No surprise, Tyler Newsom boots it through the end zone. So Griffin starts at their 20.
I'm very interested to see the type of adjustments that head coach for the Carrollton has made on the defense side of the ball. You know, you look at these Parks number and what he's done in this football game here, John. Three touchdowns, 229 yards through the air. And most importantly, look what he's done with his feet, 93 yards. And through scrambles that he didn't have to, but which he chose to do because he had time in the park and nobody was open downfield.
Six completions for 288 yards, 311 total yards of offense by Parks by himself. Wide open on the sidelines at the 40, out past midfield. First down, Griffin is at it again. Keaston Fuller with the catch and the big gain of 31.
Something's going on. I don't know what it is on the defense side of the ball for Carrollton. It may be the communication. Maybe somebody's not getting the play call, but these cornerbacks are off. These safeties are not on the same page.
And this is Griffin's pace. You're going to see four and five wide in the pattern, three up top, two down low. Make sure that they're seven on the line and set for a second. Snap to Parks. Zone read, draw, 50, 45, 40, inside the 40, close to the 35-yard line, down to the 36, gain of 13.
Keep in mind, they do not have a running game. But Parks has taken upon himself to become the running game in this state championship game tonight, and he's done a fairly well, good job doing that.
Malik Miller, their lead running back, out, for those of you that missed that story off the top of the show, was hurt celebrating a touchdown in the win against Sandy Creek. Suffered one of those Malcolm Mitchell broken tibia fibula injuries, and so it's either Devontae Freeman or Jaquez Parks. Wide open, 35 down to the 30, kicking it inside. Inside the 25, down to the 23, gain of 13, and another first.
As you can see, a great decision. As you can see, this defense is dropping back into cover two in its zone. And hey, you have a number one receiver out there, acts like he's going to run around, but he sticks around. That is the check down in this offense when you have four or five wide. And you can see the check down right there. Usually the running back will be your check down, but in the way this defense is playing, the receivers become the check down.
Another play up and running for Griffin. This is their pace. Down close to the 10. Let's show you that last play as it happened. Right there, right down the seam. Down to the 11-yard line for another first down. Darquavius Mangum with the catch. Another quick inside on the slant. Touchdown, Griffin. Trey Willis. Eleven yards on the catch for Willis. His third touchdown catch. Touchdown replay brought to us by our friends, Technical College System of Georgia. TCSG, learn more, earn more, and Willis did just there.
When you see the linebackers playing off and the safety coming up, rolling to play man-to-man on their best receiver, he's been beating his secondary all evening. You got to like that matchup.
Willis getting looks from places like Western Kentucky and South Alabama on track scholarships. Point after is up and good. Griffin's lead back up to 15 at 42-27, a minute one in to the third quarter.
As you can see, his main target here, this man-to-man up right here on the safety. And just nice, quick slant right there. Very easy pass and very easy decision.
Saw where the blitzing linebacker was coming from, went to the slant receiver, turned out to be Willis. for the score. Here's your scoring drive. 80 yards, 5 plays, 61 seconds. Once again, scoring drive brought to us by our friends at TCSG. And there's Willis's numbers. I don't have to, I need a calculator to figure that out. 6 for 161. So you're looking at 25 yards a catch right now for Griffin. All of his catches have been for substantive yards all night long for Griffin. And all 5 plays of this past drive for Griffin were longer than 10 yards a shot.
I'm going to tell you right now, I saw a lot of coaches on the sideline this weekend. Kirby Smart's in town, Mark Rick in town, a lot of big dogs. Florida State's been here, Clemson's here. And the way Trey Willis is playing tonight, I'm sure he's going to catch the name and catch the eye of some big time schools.
Pooch kick picked up by Jarvis Terrell. And he's out of bounds close to the 30-yard line. So short field created for Carrollton off the return by the sophomore.
As you can see, some of that 10-6 speed, the 100 meters by Terrell is getting to the crease, of this special team play right there in that lane with the blockers out in front. Malik Shepherd leading the way.
Trey Shivers all part of it. All 3 of those running backs key on special teams. And they're going to start at the 28-yard line. Short field, easy pickings right now for this Carrollton offense.
You can see the kicker out there trying to stop, but he didn't want no parts of that tackle.
Dive, second man through, nothing happening there. So it'll be second down after the loss of a couple. Nike Floyd leading everyone for Griffin to stop Trey Shivers.
Got to like this defense attack. You just see how these guys work well to push up the middle.
Fake the dive, give to the second man through, and there were 4 Griffin guys chasing after Shivers there on the carry. And he's looking up right there, going after that left knee. Shivers trying to play it off.
Jonathan Frost getting down there and made that contact with this helmet on his knee.
It'll be interesting to see how Shivers' effectiveness continues after this point. Jet sweep fake Garrett up the middle inside the 20, down close to the 17. So it looks like they'll move the sticks on the move by Garrett. 10, possibly 11 yards, depending on the spot. They'll give him the 18. They'll give him 10 and a first.
Garrett, the 2-year starter, decided to make the right read. The defense had their eye on the running back there. That's why it's always important, like I was talking about, to follow out your fakes. And the defense, don't expect the quarterback to run the football. It's a very nice job to get the first down by Garrett.
First and 10 from the Griffin 18. Fake the jet sweep, hangs on to it again, and it's another 10, still driving down to the 5-yard line. 13 more for Garrett, first and goal Trojans.
Defense and special teams, and once again, a big-time special teams by Jarvis Terrell coming down there to keep this drive going to set his offense up for a very nice field position. Now Garrett taking his time running this offense. As he knows, 2-year starter here.
Wing tee set. Whistles on the field. Timeout Griffin.
And that was a true wing tee set too.
Timeout Griffin.
With Cole Cook on the edge.
So let's take a look at what Carrollton has been able to accomplish as a very storied program. 7-time state champs. Ben Scott was the last in 1998. Charlie Grisham, one of the mainstays of Carrollton's football history. 29 region championships. 10 wins in 20 of the last 25 years. 181 All-Staters, and there's the numbers by Charlie Grisham down there, coached for 29 seasons. 261, 69, and 13 for those 5 titles.
Yeah.
And since the mid-50s, Carrollton has only had 4 coaches. Charlie Grisham, Ben Scott, Ross New, and that man right there, Ray Van Teague. So that says a lot about the stability and what the coaches that go to Carrollton are able to work with.
Yeah, I remember, you know, Reggie Brown played at Georgia with me. He was a great receiver that came out of Carrollton. And he talked about his program, how well it was just ran and how disciplined the football team year in and year out. And you can just tell tonight and just look at these guys just throwing their best punts, going at it.
First and goal from the 5. Shivers in motion. Gets the jet sweep on the cut and works his way into the end zone. Broke the plane with the football beforehand. Trey Shivers, 5 yards and a score.
I want you to pay attention to the second effort that Shivers gave right at the end to cross the plane. As you see this defense, they know he's going to have the rock in his hand. You can see he has 2 defenders trying to wrap him up. Look at that effort. Look at him driving his feet. That's what it's all about.
I want to apologize for the folks out in Carroll County for calling him by the wrong pronunciation, because as we all know, it's important to the family, so it's important to us. And by that, we mean the Carrollton Trojan family, and they're looking for the fake on the 2-point. They got it. Brandon Walton released, got the 2-point conversion. Cuts it to 7 at 42-35.
Wow. Gutsy call. That's a very nice job by executing on Carrollton. As you can see, it's one of his main targets going out there. Cole Cook just being in the right place, and the defender just runs right by him.
That's what you always see, because with the quarterback who is the holder, with Jaquez Parks for Griffin, with Will Garrett for Carrollton, got the 2-point conversion. 2 minutes, 49 seconds in. Big plays on this drive by Garrett, running the football up the middle.
Yeah, that's why it's always important to go through your fakes. And I talked about that in the beginning of the game. He does a really good job going through his progressions and, you know, handing the ball up to his running backs. But it's going to come a time in the game when you have to take it in your own hands. And he did a really good job of that on this drive.
Garrett finding Brandon Walton there for the 2-point conversion, 7-point game. Tyler Newsom squibs it this time. And is it going to go out of bounds? No, picked up at the 3. 10, 15, 20. Found the sideline. One man to beat. Newsom couldn't grab it. Let's see if Carrollton can catch up. The answer, no. 98 yards on the kickoff return. Carrollton answers 48-35.
Look at that. Look at that. Anything you can do, Carrollton, I can do it better, says Griffin.
Squid kick by Newsom, picked up at the 2 or the 3. Found the sideline. Great seal block there. There's Newsom. Move there. Carrollton chasing. One last dive at the ankles. Doesn't work. And another touchdown for Willis. Trey Willis's 4th touchdown of the night. 3 through the air, 1 on special teams. And the point after puts the margin back up to 2 touchdowns at 49-35.
Trey Willis has been a main factor in this football game. As you can see, he just gets to the outside and he just go along the sideline right there to the house, and watch the seal block right there. That's exactly what you want to see.
Willis picking him up and putting him down. Total offense for Willis on the evening.
Willis
is talking 250 total yards of total offense.
And you look at Willis, you look at his size, and you look at all the things that he has on the football field, but you look at his form, the way he runs. He's a track guy. You can tell he's a track guy. When he gets in the open field, he doesn't turn it to another gear. It's just he just consistently stay consistent. You think he's not that fast, but when you have technique and you're running trying to catch someone like that, he's faster than what he seems to be.
259 total yards of offense, averaging 27 yards a catch, plus the 98-yard kickoff return. Not a bad night.
And you can see the frustration of the coaches of Carrollton just talking with each other. It's getting kind of chippy down there. And he said, "Coach, I don't know what's going on, Coach. What did you see?"
Pooch kick. Fielded. Shivers at the 21, 25. Tries to dodge, tackles, does. Gets a block, gets some help, but it gets back to the 21, so Carrollton will start there.
You talk about game tackling. that's what keeps the intensity level high, and that's what keeps the momentum on your side. You look at these coaches, they're trying to, hey, talk to me. I don't want to talk to you. Let's fix this thing. You know, this is for all the marbles right now. And these coaches, you know, they put in the same hours together and they work together year in and year out. But a lot is at stake.
There's your X's and O talk right there, head coach Ray Van Teague. Trying to stop the points that Griffin's been putting on the board. 8:51 for the third. Garrett rolling, looking, settles down in the zone. Andrew Turner for the catch, takes him out to pass the 40-yard line, gain of 17, and a first down for the Trojans as they move the sticks.
We've been seeing a lot of passes tonight from Carrollton, and that's not their forte, John. And getting Will out the pocket, giving him some high percentage passes, some safe passes, some comebacks, some outs, some slants, some crossing routes has really been giving Griffin some trouble tonight on the defense side of the ball in the passing game.
Wing T set for Carrollton, motion to the near. Jet sweep trying to find the corner, Terrell. And he finds five Griffin Bears on defense instead, no gain.
Good job by the defense, just running inside out, and the speed sweeps has been giving them a big time trouble tonight, just trying to stay at them and cutting back. Kudos to the cornerback and the Will linebacker staying on the outside, keeping an outside hand free to make the tackle.
Quavius Davis in on the tackle, number 99. All 6 foot, 250 pounds of him, the senior anchoring that four-man front, 668 total yards of offense as we approach 30 minutes of play. Garrett thinking about going long, will tuck it and run. He's undercut at the 40-yard line. Once again, Davis getting in the middle of it.
Our first sighting of the cooler. Once again, Sloan just coming up, chopping him down low. And he's definitely going to feel that one in the morning.
Here's Ronquavius Davis. You've seen Telly Sloan most of the evening. Davis, one of the team leaders in sacks with 8. 9 hurries on the season, so he's known to pressure the quarterback. Third down and 6. The 44-yard line of Carrollton. Shivers motion and a neutral zone infraction once more. Hits him to a 3rd and 1.
Dead ball, encroachment on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Still 3rd down.
Moves him 5 yards closer. Raven Tirado, what's up?
Guys, I'm over here on the Carrollton sideline, and I have to say it's a bit somber. A lot of guys shaking their head, especially the defensive players. I didn't get to get up in the heat of battle between the coordinator and Coach Raven, if you will. But it seems they're very heated. They're trying to get figure things out. Also, one of the coaches was like, man, we've got to make a stop. We have to stop them. Obviously, stating the obvious. Back up to you, John.
Thank you, Raven. 6:40 and counting. 3rd quarter. Garrett goes on the plunge, gets the first down crossing the 50. So it'll be another set of downs for Carrollton. As we approach the halfway point here in the 3rd quarter, Carrollton trying to end up with more points on the board in this back and forth that has 84 total points so far, and we haven't hit the halfway point of the 3rd quarter.
Here's the thing. You've seen a lot of special teams play and from both of these teams, and it's really been helping both these teams. That's why you see a lot of points on the board in the state championship. Special teams always sets up field position for your offense, and both of these offenses have been in good position all night to start off with.
Shotgun, quick screen out to Shivers by the edge, tackled at the 45-yard line. You'll see where forward progress is.
It's a very nice job by Devontae Freeman coming up, attempting to make that tackle to stop Shivers out there in the open field. This is their go-to guy in the open field. You see the cornerback coming up right here in the bottom of the screen and just making something happen. A nice game tackling by number 5 coming, working inside out, Nick Williams.
Loss of 5, 2nd down and 15. We'll see what happens this time. Sweep across. Terrell grabbed by the waist and jerked down just shy of the 50, back to the 48. So a gain of 3.
Nick Williams once again getting into the middle of it, number five there for Griffin. So it's going to be third down and 12. Under normal situations, you'd sit there and say, well, okay, Carrollton, third and 12. They only pass seven times a game coming in, but they've had great success tonight passing the football.
I'm looking for Andrew Turner on this play. He's been doing a really good job, maybe a curl route or a deep crossing route across the middle for Cole Cook.
Turner, bottom of your screen. Garrett dropping back, looking, trying to go over the top, trying to find Shivers. Just overthrows him by a step or two, incomplete.
Oh, they try to run a wheel route with Shivers coming out that backfield with number one, with Andrew Turner running the safety off and running the corner off, and Shivers coming up behind him along the sideline.
Now check this out. Ball control, we talk about time of possession, sometimes meaningful, sometimes not. 670 yards of offense. Griffin's won half the plays Carrollton has.
And that's what the offense is all about, is, you know, grind. Let's get as many of the plays as we can.
Punt in the air, end over end, picked up at the 10. Near side, big block to Seal, but chased out of bounds after a 7-yard return, 42-yard punt. And that's where Griffin will start once again on offense. And Carrollton is looking for a stop. And Griffin, we just did the math, used a calculator, did some really fancy things. Almost 14 yards of play.
Yeah.
Not 14 yards of pass play, 14 yards on the ground, 14 yards of play.
Two reasons. Jaquez Parks and Trey Willis has been vital to this offense tonight.
Three wide receivers for Griffin. Parks dropping back, clear out, wide open, 25, 30, 35 yard line, first down. Keep the clock moving, but they'll move the sticks.
And that is the check down route of this offense. Wings out there getting into space, hanging out on the sideline, just making a nice catch to move the chains.
Gain of 18. They'll start things back up at the 35. First down. Five receivers now for Griffin.
You know, another three-man rush here. Somebody has to make a play when you rush three. They really haven't made any plays rushing three tonight.
Parks on the keep. First down. Gain of 11. But the one thing that you notice before the snap of the ball, the right-hand side of the offensive line closed their split to create a man advantage. 4-on-2 rushing for Carrollton. Let's take a look. There's your Seal. Parks tucks it, and it's 4-on-2, and then it turns into a 4-on-3. When you've got the man advantage, you run that way, and you gain 11 for a first. Parks dropping pressure. Looks like he's going to tuck it and run. 50, 45, 40. A lot of room. Too much room. Cuts a tackle down to the 25, gain of 21.
Here's what's wrong in this defense. You give this quarterback this much time, and when you're dropping seven or eight players, you don't have anybody in the intermediate level of your defense. So that gives your quarterback enough time just to see everything and see all the holes. That's why he's doing a good job. That's why he has over 100 yards rushing tonight.
Five in the pattern for Griffin. Standard fare this evening. Quick slant, picked up, complete. Christian Owens heading to the University of Georgia. Only a junior, 6'5", 215 pounds. Big catch right in the slot.
You see him, it's a very nice, stout route. It's a quick out. Big tight end for him. It's one of the routes that Coach talked about. He said, we like his size. We like to see him. And another quick route for him.
Once more, the dump off down to the 10-yard line. And these two pass plays to Christian Owens, you'd have to go back 12 plays to figure out when the last time it was that they didn't have a 10-yard plus play. They are getting first downs every single time and more as they touch the football. Parks pressured, rolling out, stumbling, falling at the 18.
About time this defensive line just closing that gap up in there. Malik Shepard up on the edge coming up there. doing a really good job getting that sack. Cole Cook on the defense side of the ball, too, playing defensive line.
6'6", 225, heading to NC State. Third down and 13. Big stop needed here for Carrollton. Five in the pattern for the Griffin Bears. Parks looking, looking. Good coverage by Carrollton. Now pressured and flushed. Back to the 35. He's got to get rid of it. He does. Off his back foot floater into the end zone. Knocked out of the way and intercepted. Carrollton's thinking about running it out. Dangerous out to the 4-yard line. Looks like they got the turnover that they needed.
Yeah.
But ran it out of the end zone.
Sam Turner just staying back there, staying active, always around the ball. The fifth interception on the year for him.
We're going to take a timeout as they change possessions. What's going to happen the rest of the Quad A final coming up on GPB? Welcome back, Georgia Dome. 2:01 for the third. Griffin leading 49-35. Jaquez Parks not happy with himself after this last play.
Yeah, this is a very bad decision. Trying to do a little bit too much. He probably should have thrown the ball away. He went to the sideline, put his head between his hands. But this is just a mental error by the quarterback here. He's trying to make something happen.
Carrollton players trying to knock it down, and it ends up being intercepted and run out by Sam Turner to the 4-yard line. You saw Dante Wigley try to knock it down. Sam Turner picks it up, tries to create something, and here's Park's reaction.
Yep. That's the last thing you want to see from your leader of your team. You know, coach over there giving those guys a pep talk. Talking to his offensive coordinator on the headset upstairs next to us. Trying to explain, hey, coach, this is what I saw.
Trying to create something back at the 35-yard line. So 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Griffin down two scores. Wing T set out of the 4-yard line. Short gain there on first down. Dante Wigley getting a carry for a change. A little variety for Carrollton in their offense. They're going to say Wigley got four, second and six.
Tonight on defense, I've noticed Griffin's, every time they run that speed sweep, Griffin has a tendency of overrunning the running back, and that's why the cutback lane is wide open for positive yardage.
Up the middle. 13-14 yard line. Once again, getting chunks. Malik Shepard getting yards. The 5'9", 180-pound senior. Getting it to a third and short. Third and a long one, maybe. Carrollton fans trying to rally their troops down 14. Under a minute to go, third quarter, but as we know, the way that this game has gone, 14 points can happen very, very quickly. Garrett plunges first down. He'll move the sticks.
It's a nice call for Garrett. A big offensive lineman up front, falling behind. Big number, 78. Jake Sanders.
Heading to Duke. All 6'6", 325 pounds of him right there on the right-hand side of your screen, number 78.
That's a lot of meat up front there, John.
325 at left tackle, 220 at left guard, 230 at center, 270 at right guard in Jacob King, 290 at right tackle in Joe Sear.
That pants crucial deal is hot.
Jet sweep coming around the corner, 20, 25, fighting for yards is Jarvis Terrell. See where they spot him, give him 9 or give him 10. Looks like they're going to look at it. Figure out whether or not it's a first down or if it's second and short and probably the end of the third quarter.
That's a very nice move of Jarvis Terrell, just staying alive, staying active. And you see Deontay Freeman running off the field there.
Second down and short. It looks like Carrollton's either going to snap it quickly or they're just going to stand and sit on it for the rest of the quarter. Not going to get the snap off in time. A somewhat calmer third quarter. Only a couple of scores on the board. But 12 minutes to go for the Quad A championship. Griffin and Carrollton trading blows. Who's going to get their first championship in a long time? The answer when we come back on the great GPB. Carrollton and Griffin. Griffin Bears 49-35. A lot of offense, a lot of excitement, and a lot of stuff happening when we come back to the Georgia Dome on the great GPB.
My husband, Corky Kill, was a beloved father, husband, and coach. Corky passed away from lung cancer less than 7 months after his diagnosis. Lung cancer is curable if diagnosed early. Unfortunately, there are many people who are at risk but can't afford an early screening.
Early lung cancer screenings help save lives. A message from Corky Kell Early Lung Cancer Detection Fund. For information, 770-956-GIVE.
Hi folks, Butch Miller from Milton Martin Honda in Gainesville, wishing you and yours a Merry Christmas and the happiest of New Years. But if you think that the folks at Milton Martin Honda in Gainesville are proud to be supporters of Georgia High School Athletics,
you got that right!
Drop down and enter a world most people overlook.
Riverheads have a pretty fantastic natural history, and it starts and ends on the Georgia beach.
So amazing when they hit you with their wings, it's like... this is stuff we're finding.
That was so helpful.
You must remember your son needs you.
You have put up with so much. Don't you want to be with me?
You mean living in sin?
There's going to be changes at Downton.
Nothing is settled.
I can't stop thinking about you. I can't hold it in anymore.
During this performance, one student will drop out of high school. Be there for your big finish.
Welcome back, Georgia Dome. Final 12 minutes for the Quad A Championship. 84 points on the board. Let's send it downstairs to Grace Olson. Grace.
Thanks, John. All of our viewers at home sure do know their football. I quiz you guys in the second quarter. I asked, what former Griffin player won a Super Bowl ring with Mike Ditka's famous 1985 Chicago Bears? The answer, Willie Gault. We had so many responses on Facebook and Twitter, but our trivia winner of the night is Tony Tiger. Tony, you get a GPB Football Fridays in Georgia t-shirt. Thank you, everyone who responded. Let's keep it going. We've got a lot of trivia going throughout the day. We've got another one in the next game coming up, so stay tuned. John?
Tony Tiger.
Shout out to Tony Tiger.
Tony Tiger answers a question about the Bears, so all we're missing is the Lions, right?
Oh, my.
See, now you're playing. Now you're with it.
It's all about having fun, John. It's been a fun, exciting year, man.
So let's see how the final 12 minutes go in Quad A with Griffin up two scores. Carrollton from their own 26. Garrett looking over the top, throwing into double coverage. Caught down to the 15-yard line. Andrew Turner, a gain of 60.
Coach said, just throw it up in the area. Mr. Turner will find it. Mr. Satellite himself. Turner just running up under that ball. Two crossing routes. You see a crossing route from the X receiver and another one come across the middle, a deep post. You got to look, if you look at the arm of Will Garrett, yeah, he definitely can run it, but he definitely can throw the football as well.
There's Turner, long gone. Mark from behind. Mark from the front. Dragged down.
Defensive back just looking up at that ball. You got to look at the receiver because, hey, you're slowing yourself up when you're running in the air. It's easy to run fast when you're looking at a target.
Three wide. Jet sweep, nothing happening, loss of six.
There he is again, number five, Nick Williams. Guy has 111 tackles going into this football game. You can see the effort, defensive effort, staying outside, keeping that outside contained. That's your job as a will linebacker, to scrape those edges, to make those plays in space. Nice talent. Had 21 tackles for a loss coming into this football game, and you can see the reason why. He's active in the backfield.
Loss of six, second and 16 from the 21. Got to get to the five for a first down. Three wide receivers in the pattern. Terrell in motion to the near. Garrett has an outlet. Faked the run. Tucked it. Got a couple. Back to the original line of scrimmage, or close to it. And it looks like Ronquavious Davis is down.
Hey, you come up at the last bottom of the screen. He's just bump with Will's leg and his leg at the same time. It's a nice little rollout. Didn't have anything there, and Nick Williams coming up with the tackle along with Ronquavious Davis.
You need any contact. That's what the physios are looking at right now. So let's take a look at what the Trojans have done in the last 5 years in the playoffs. Traditionally, week 11, week 12, they're always here. You always know that the Carrollton Trojans are going to be there. Marist, I think it's mandatory that any game that Carrollton has with Marist must go multiple overtimes.
Yes, it is.
This year, to beat Marist, it went four. Last year at Hugh Spalding, it went five in the second round. Lost to Peach County in the quarters in 2011. Shot saw them here against Sandy Creek. That fumble at the goal line as they were driving to tie in 2010, and then lost to Eastside in the second round in 2008 and 2009 by 7 points and 12 points. And Davis is being helped off the field.
Yeah, hopefully he can get himself together. And, you know, it's kind of hard. That's a big blow for them on that defensive line. And he had a brace on it already. It was taped up.
So let's take a look at the knee-to-knee contact right here at the end. Right there on the plant, it looked like.
Yeah, kind of. He made the tackle, but also his leg. I believe his foot got stuck as he was making the tackle, and all that pressure from the tackle landed on that knee.
So that's going to put that much more pressure on guys like Nike Floyd, Noah Clowers, Jonathan Frost across the front.
And they have players. They have defensive linemen up there. It's been there. And like you said, this has been a long time for this team to be in this game.
Three wide. Terrell on the jet sweep. Tries to cut it outside. Does to about the 13-yard line. Nick Williams again on the tackle for Griffin.
I want to point this young man out here, man. He's doing a great job tonight. How he stays outside and just keep fighting off that block. Just making sure that he stays and keep that outside arm free to make this tackle on third down to force the fourth down play.
Fourth down for Carrollton. They know that they need touchdowns to match Griffin. Big point in the ball game here. Can Carrollton continue to match score for score with Griffin? Garrett on the rollout, going to cut it back. Looks like he's going to be close to the first down. Stutter step. He's not going to get there, just short.
And look who it is. He tried to fake the cooler out. The cooler went for the first draw of the blood. He missed him, but he also regained to make the tackle.
Watch six black middle of your screen.
Comes back up. The play's not over. That's a football play. That's a football play. He's trying to make it happen with his leg. Give him a nice move. And that right there, we used to practice that move in mat drills at Georgia. You're chopping your feet. You hit the mat, and you got to roll over and run to the cone. Everything translates to the football field.
Outlet pass by Parks, complete and out of bounds. And for those of you following along, leading into today, regardless of classification, the most points ever scored in a title game, 74. Before this year, when Valdosta beat Avondale 62-12. Tucker Creekside had 80 last night to set the new record, and now with 84 and counting, we've set a record off the new record.
The setting records here on Georgia Public Broadcasting. You saw it with your own eyes, so you made history with us.
Parks up the middle, gets it to the 21-yard line. They'll move the sticks, and right now it looks like Coach Dvorsny's just interested in running clock while they are still in that 4 and 5 wide receiver set.
Uses this offense as a tempo, fast pace, and you're going to see them slow it down here a little bit to get some of this clock aiding up. They want to try to get home with a win.
Slant gets more yards.
And the only
that's
way
what it's been doing all night long.
The only way this Carrollton defense is going to survive, they can't just sit back and be vanilla. They can't sit back and just allow Griffin to pick them apart. They have to start attacking. They have to start sending some blitz. They have to start doing some stunts on the offensive defensive line.
More yards for Willis and his big night. 265 total yards for him on offense and special teams. Parks will tuck, 35. Cuts it to the outside. I thought he was going out of bounds. Is he going to outrun them? The answer, yes. 73 yards, Jaquez Parks.
Nobody wants it more than that guy right there, man. You can just tell by his body language. You can tell the way he ran the football. Nobody wants it more than him right now.
Here's Parks. He looks like he's running out of bounds, and he dodges the one tackle, sees the alley, and he's gone. Touchdown replay brought to us by our friends of the Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. And they definitely learned and earned it tonight. Swinging gate right now for the point after.
3.8 GPA average. Jaquez Parks, smart kid, very talented. He completes 72% of his passes on the rating. Coach talked about how he really just enjoys watching film. He stays after with the GAs, the graduate assistants, just helping him out and just breaking down film. Most importantly, his head coach said this about him: he's the best QB I ever had here at Griffin.
And you're watching him at Georgia Public Broadcasting under the big top. Big run for Jaquez Parks that has broken the back of the Carrollton Trojans. Griffin 8 minutes away from their first state title in 35 years on the great GPB.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la.
Want more joy this holiday?
Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la.
Proudly serving Georgia for over 40 years, 83 locations across the state, Church's Chicken supports Georgia high school football on GPB and wishes all the teams good luck. Open before and after the game, it's Church's, where you always get more.
Welcome back, Georgia Dome, 808 regulation. Griffin up 3 scores. Jaquez Parks deserves a breather after picking up 73 yards on the ground.
Young man, not quite sure where he's going to go to school, but if you look on the outside here, he's going to follow some of his blocking. But I want to point out another receiver blocking right there, the effort he's giving, making sure he sealed the edge for his quarterback. It's all about blocking, and I'm telling you, to get to the next level as a receiver, you have to be able to block. You have to be able to always keep your eyes down the field and help out. College coaches, pay attention to that, baby.
Trey Willis on the edge with the block. They've had a busy night. There's your scoring drive, thanks to us by our friends at TCSG. 94 covered in 4, 73 by Jaquez Parks, 77 seconds off the clock. 529 yards of total offense, 15 passes for 341, 13 carries for 188. Staggering numbers offensively have been put up in the most prolific scoring high school football championship game in the history of Georgia high school football. 91 points, and we still have 8 minutes to go.
Still 8 minutes to go, and most importantly, a lot of football to be played.
Picked up. Turner at the 35, hit by 4 Griffin guys, and that's where Carrollton will start. tough Griffin defense shutting down Jarvis Terrell.
And the reason why they're shutting him down, they're staying on the outside. They're shooting those gaps. Those defensive linemen are helping freeing up those linebackers coming in. And most importantly, the defense running to the football. You cannot win championships if you don't have a high-talented type defense running to the football and making those type of plays right there that Nick Williams is taking advantage of all night long, baby. This Griffin defense is finally hunkered down.
Terrell, only a sophomore. He'll have a lot more time to do a lot of great things for the folks in Carrollton. Pass completing into Andrew Turner. Gets him 7. They need him in bigger chunks than that with under 8 minutes to go.
Something Carrollton has been doing all night and having some success at it, which is passing the football. Expect a heavy dose of passing and a heavy dose of Andrew Turner. Cole Cook as well. These guys have definitely been a big specimen to the passing game all season.
Second and short for Carrollton. 4 wide. Motion to the near. Garrett behind the coverage. Incomplete and overthrown.
We talked about this Walton's defense and look at how they shut down teams all year long. John
started with Oxford, Alabama. They had 5 folks missing in that 35-14 win. Calhoun, always a tough opponent, 142-7. Then you get into region play. 1-4 overtimes against Marist, the 1 loss to Sandy Creek, the blemish that has stuck with them the entire time. Tough matchup against Monroe area in the playoffs. Tougher matchup against Stockbridge in the playoffs. Carrollton's put up a lot of amazing numbers. Terrell met close to the first down mark. We're going to be 4th and short, or depending on the spot. Let's see what they do here.
Yeah, that's.
It's either it. They're going to give him first down. Nose of the football and move the sticks.
Yeah, you look at that block buck. I don't know if you want to, if we can roll that back, but I want to look and give you that Cole Cook just came up and just leveled.
Dodson there, 26. Look, here's one more look.
If you look at this block right here coming in your screen, right there.
Big block to knock somebody down. First down yardage, 4 receivers for Garrett. Mishandled the snap, and he knee down after he picked it up. Back to the 37. Clock's going to continue to roll. Loss of 8. Ray Van Teague looking for answers, down 3 scores, and he's got to get them on the board quickly. They scored twice early on to take a 14-0 lead in 2 minutes and 20 seconds. They need that kind of magic here. Shivers with touchdown runs of 24 and 9 to give them that 14-point advantage. Let's see what Garrett does here. Rolling out pressure, spins away, pressure from behind, and a sack back at the 34. Nike Floyd with the sack.
Still no spottings of Rockamius Davis. You said, John, hey, this defensive line has to step up, and they definitely have some players on the defensive line stepping up. Look at Floyd just making a great effort running the quarterback down from behind. That's why it's so important to run to the football.
3rd and 21 as we're under the halfway point for Carrollton to come back from a 56-35 deficit here in the Quad A Championship, chasing after their first title in 15 years. Last finals appearance 3 years ago. Garrett winding up and throwing into double coverage, intercepted. They're going to call it incomplete.
The quarterback is out there.
Jaquez Parks trying to get some activity on defense.
You know what? Smart move by the coaches, because you know the deep ball was coming.
Had it, but he dropped it.
You can just look at the ball, how it's sailing up there, and he goes up top with both hands, and just goes right through his arms.
Had it and through his hands. Parks has seen some duty in multiple DB packages tonight. I remember him in one goal line package where he was a defensive back. So what is it about championship games? You want to have your best athletes out on the field?
You definitely want to do that. It's a must win, and they definitely have to watch out for the fake punt too as well, because
that's why you've got a diamond formation about 10 yards further back. Punt is away, doesn't turn over. Out of bounds at the 22-yard line. Injury update. Raven Tirado, what's going on?
Yes, John, number 99, Davis for Griffin. He will be out for the remainder of the game. He subflexed his kneecap. I'm not a doctor, so I'm not sure what that means, but it doesn't sound good. While they've been working on him, wrapping him up, he's almost been in tears. He keeps saying, I'm going back in. I'm not finishing it out like this, but if the trainers have it their way, we won't be seeing him for the rest of this state championship game. Back to you, John.
Big loss to that front line for Griffin. Thank you, Raven. Now Griffin's going to try to run their offense with the offensive version of Jaquez Parks. 5:12 to go. Regulation. 23-yard line. Screen game is open if he wants it. Looking, finds the side screen at the 15-yard line. Down to the 20. Loss of a couple. But more importantly for Griffin, clock ticks. Under 5 minutes.
Nice open field tackle by Brandon Walton. Home has 6.5 sacks coming into this football game. His space is kind of hard to tackle those guys, those athletes on the receivers, but asking the defensive end to tackle a receiver, that's a pretty good job.
Griffin looking to milk the clock here. Play clock under 10. Parks, zone read, draw, 20, 25, looking for an opening up to the 30, maybe the 31-yard line, so he gets 10 to create a third and short.
You would think here with Carrollton, with maybe looking to start using some of those timeouts. As you look there, they have three, Griffin two.
Or do you need him for offense?
It's a good
trust your
good
defense,
sign.
Which you've trusted all year long, to get this third and short here taken care of, change of possession. As we get under 4 minutes.
You look at tonight, well, this Carrollton defense struggled holding this Griffin's offense. So, and you know what Griffin's trying to do. They're trying to milk this thing on out.
Five in the pattern. Once again, draw play. Jaquez Parks, first down out close to the 40-yard line. Now, with Griffin, you see the wristbands that the players have. They do have play cards. The second guy has play cards, and they have associating numbers.
I like the UGA helmet.
I bet you do. There's the wristband. 161 plays are on that wristband, or that was a couple of weeks ago. 161 plays on that, and it's all color-coded. You go with the card, you go with the number, you look to the wristband, and that's your play. Divided in half, left side of the field, right side of the field. Draw again, Parks, and he's just going to sit down at the 48.
Smart decision by Parks, just getting on down. And now, if you care to, now you want to start using those timeouts. The second down, 1 yard to go.
3 minutes.
And as you can see, the second team of Griffin coming on in, and one guy's not happy about that. Look, I can tell by his body language coming off the field is Mr. Parks himself.
16 carries for Parks, 216 yards.
He's over there talking to his coach. His coach says, hey, man, you had your time. The game's won.
Running play up the middle. Jaquez Parks getting some time on the sidelines. May have been his curtain call. Right now, Anthony Stroud in, number 16 at quarterback. And there's Parks. He's had a busy night. In the 46 minutes that he played, active on defense, knocking down passes, active on offense, running and passing the football. Huge numbers for Griffin tonight offensively. 557 total yards of offense for Parks, 338 through the air, 219 through the ground.
And also, the question mark around Parks, you know, what is he going to do? Is he, you know, coach talked about him going into the Air Force. Also, talk about some of the choices, some of the schools that offered him, like Air Force and Harvard, Western Carolina. He's a good football player.
There's the cooler.
He still doesn't have any type of face expressions.
It's all business. This is a business trip for Telly Sloan. All business.
I love the story.
Here's Coach Dvorsny, who's also all business for the last 100 seconds.
I love the story Coach told. He talked about the cooler. He talked about how he's not allowed to participate in any live activity in practice because he knocked two players out and gave them concussions in practice.
Handoff off the right guard. Devontae Freeman getting some yards. Last 5 years, first round exit to Monroe. 2 years before that, losing to Tucker in Statesboro. Semifinals the year before that. Former coach Lloyd Bohannon, whose record Steve Dvorsny is chasing at Griffin, came and visited the team to tell them what this week is supposed to be like, what it's like to chase after a state championship. And for the next 45 seconds, Steve Dvorsny is going to be all business, but you've got to take your hat off to Carrollton. Great run by the Trojans. Freeman for more yards off of the right guard. 1998, last title 2010, last finals appearance. Griffin soaking it in the last 25 seconds.
Kudos to this team. They worked hard. It's been a long year. He finally has the monkey off his back as a coach. Gave this community something to be proud of. And you have to thank these parents too, you know, both teams. The long hours that they put in with their boys and girls. Just being there with them for the long hours.
35 years in the making, the Griffin Bears are state champs. Shakes on the field happening right now. We're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, we're going to come back with the trophy presentation, the post-game show, and the 6A championship. Norcross and North Gwinnett coming up on the great GPB Griffin, your Quad A champs.
The GHSA championship is made possible in part by Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporation, lighting the way. Technical College System of Georgia. Learn more, earn more. And by viewers like you. Thank you. The GHSA would like to thank the Georgia Farm Bureau.
The wheels of progress haven't been very active lately. But because of business people like you, things are beginning to get rolling. And Regions is here to help, making it easier with the expertise and service to keep those wheels turning. From business loans to cash management, we want to be your partner moving forward. Let's get going together.
As the demand for power grows,
Georgia's nonprofit,
member-owned electric cooperatives
are committed to providing safe,
affordable,
and reliable electricity
to our members. We've been dedicated
to building strong
communities
for more than 70 years
and are proud to join
the Georgia High School Association and Georgia Public Broadcasting
in support of our state's student athletes.
We are Georgia EMC, lighting the way.
Nothing prepares you better for a great career than the 25 colleges of the Technical College System of Georgia. TCSG colleges produce graduates with the knowledge and training today's top employers are looking for. With campuses across Georgia, state-of-the-art facilities, and outstanding instructors with real-world experience, it's the kind of affordable college education that will fast-track you into a rewarding career. We're building a better future for you. Contact the TCSG college in your area today or go to tcsg.edu.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
Welcome back to the Georgia Dome, guys. I'm here with a state championship and some family. Coach, you don't have a lot of excitement, but how excited are you?
I'm just so wore out, I guess, right now. I don't know how to celebrate. They say, I like you've been here, but I've never been here before, so I don't know how to act. I'm excited, though, and I'm happy for our team and our community. And, I mean, this has been a long time coming, and finally we got it, got that monkey off our back.
Absolutely. If you could describe this win in one word, what would you describe it as?
Oh, I can't do it in one word, but, I mean, it's awesome. Thank God.
definitely. Ma'am, I heard you say that it was a long, hard road. Why was that?
Road. Well, he's been working toward this for the last 13 years, and we sacrifice a lot of family time to be with these boys. These are our family, and we couldn't be more happy. They're big brothers to my girls, and we love them so much, and we appreciate our fans coming out supporting us. And community support really meant a lot tonight.
All right, well, congratulations. Back up to you, John, in the booth.
Thank you very much, Raven. Nice work downstairs. All right, sum up this championship in one word. I'll ask you.
Well, first and foremost, you know, had a score on the defense. You took it 90 yards, and then a score on the special teams that took it 98 yards. That was the difference maker in this football game.
Carrollton getting their runners-up trophies. Tremendous pedigree for the Carrollton Trojans program. And the amount of offense was stunning at points, and just how both offenses were as quick strike as they were. And we'll send it down to Mark Harmon, who has a very special presentation for Quad A champs.
Time now to present the Quad A State Championship. And for that, we go to the executive director of the GHSA, Dr. Ralph Swearingen.
Thank you, Mark. And a thank you to the two great teams that played a great game, to all the fans that came out to support. Thank you all very much. Now we have our friends from Georgia Farm Bureau who are coming to make that presentation for the state championship.
Coach Devo, on behalf of Georgia Farm Bureau Insurance Company and the Spalding County Farm Bureau, I want to congratulate you and your fellas on an undefeated season and the 2013 4A state champions.
Coach, what a moment this is. You're surrounded by your family, your team, your fan base over there. Talk a little bit about what this means.
Well, thank God first and give him the glory. But, you know, our kids, you know, they fell behind early, but they've been coming back all year, and just happy for them and our coaches and our great Griffin Nation that came to support us today.
Jaquez Parks, one of the most electrifying performances in the history of this tournament, I think. Talk a little bit about your play out there tonight.
I was just doing what I normally do and going out playing my game. That's what the coach told me, just do what I do best. I just like to give thanks to God because he the one that gave me the ability to do what I did. And I want to say thanks for all the fan base that came out there and support us. Go Bears.
One final thing, Trey, come over here. You had a kickoff return, a bunch of catches. Talk a little bit about right now what your fans mean to you over there.
It means a lot, but first and foremost, I want to thank God because without God, you know what I'm saying, you don't have the ability to do what you got to do.
All right, well, congratulations to the Griffin Bears, the 4A state champs. Congratulations. Hold that trophy high one more time. 1942, 1978, and now 2013, three state champs for the Griffin Bears. And now over to Claire and the GPB tailgate party.
Thank you so much, Mark. A lot of excited fans here in the Georgia Dome. Six games down. We have six on the books. We have one more big matchup ahead. It is going to be a big one. But before we get to the kickoff of Norcross and North Gwinnett live here at the Georgia Dome, we have a lot more of exciting things you are going to want to see. So stick around because GPB's tailgate party starts right now.